explosive when he's on the move. He's very tough to defend, number 10. Nikula gets the ball around midfield. Look, he's off to the races. The defense can't set against him. When he gets that much green, he has got a tremendous shot. Normally, he is very effective around the crease, but here he shoots from the outside. A one-step move against the defense. Comes in, takes the shot hard. It was Tom Emick who couldn't get set up against him. Give Nikula right there the credit for blowing past the defender with a hard shot on Gerrie.
Seventh goal this season, 45 career goals for Brian Nikula. And a violation on the faceoff will give the ball to the Turbos once again.
Again, the keys to the game, I put in there that Buffalo wants to win this first quarter. It's very critical because, Craig, Detroit does this to everybody. They start off explosively. They get the team down mentally, and it's very tough to climb back out of that hole.
Finneran back to get it. Here's Gerrie Gait. Gerrie Gait going in, trying to stuff it in. He does, but the officials wave it off. Crease violation.
Gerrie stepped in the crease, no doubt about it. He was in the crease when he took that shot. But that'll scare any goalie. He comes right into their face.
Double teaming by the Turbos. Holding will be the call as John Tavares very close to the crease. Too close for the Turbos. Shot from the outside, rocketed by Mahar, saves Sawicki. Ball loose behind the crease, Sawicki reels it in, outlet pass to Paul Gary. Gate streaking down the near side. One on two, one on three. Couldn't get the pass exactly where he wanted it.
Well, he was going against Kevin Alexander, who is the great Hall of Famer from Canada. He beat Kevin Alexander at midfield, and then Kevin had a chance to play defense against him around the crease. He beat Kevin again there. Kevin Alexander taught the Gate brothers how to play in the junior leagues in Canada. Here he is playing against the great one from Canada, Kevin Alexander, at 35 years old, number 26.
The teacher and the student personified. Bob Hamley trying from the angle on the right side, didn't get past Sawicki. And we played 5 minutes of this one with only one score. 1-0 Turbos. Hamilton trying to feed it into Sebastian. And on the counterattack, the Bandits. Paul Day bringing it down across midfield.
See the tempo slowing down a little bit. Both teams very eager to push the attack early on. And that pace, they couldn't keep up.
Bounce shot there by Meridian. Won't go by Sawicki.
As good as he has been, a first-team All-Pro most of his career, both of these teams have gotten a lot of confidence from their second-string goalies. Both teams won't be afraid to go to the bench.
Nikula. Oh, Gerrie with a pad save. Long pass, one on none. Shot and a score.
Makes it look easy. Beautiful shot. Now that's 26 or 28. That was 28, right? Hamley. Hamley comes down there. One-on-one. It's not as easy as it seems. Now Sawicki normally stands his ground and will make this save. Hamley didn't take many fakes. He saw a little bit of an opening over the shoulder, the left shoulder, off-stick shoulder of Sawicki. Hamley took it. Normally you go farther with this, but obviously Hamley sees a little bit of opening. Look, he sees an opening and boom, he hits it right away. Sawicki was too far to the right, maybe only a half a step, but he was showing more white than he thought he was. Hamley stung it right in the corner.
9:06 to go, first period, 1-1. And the faceoff won by the Bandits. Fast break shot taken by Emick, but Sawicki closes it there. Rough play in the corner, everyone going after the ball, including Brian Hall. 8:52 to go, we're tied at one at the JLA.
How do you get them?
I used to do aerobics till I dropped, then I found Thighmaster. Every single time you squeeze Thighmaster, you strengthen and tone right where you need it. So it's easy to squeeze your way to shapely hips and thighs.
I thought I'd never fit into these jeans again. Thank you, Thighmaster.
I recommend it and use it.
The secret to shapely thighs is exercising these muscles with just the right resistance. This balanced resistance coil is designed to give you excellent results.
Thighmaster, we may not have been born with great legs, but now we can look like we were.
To order your Thighmaster, call 1-800-533-1400. Have your credit card ready or send check or money order for $19.95 plus $4.50 for shipping.
The game of the week at Joe Louis Arena. We're tied at one between the Turbos and the Bandits.
If you just joined us, these are the two most explosive teams in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. This is all offense. It can't get...
Missile. As Sawicki played very well in the opening moments.
Both goalies have... Gerrie has had a lot of shots right in his face, and he's put the ball down the other direction.
Gerrie Gait with a behind-the-back pass to brother Paul. Inside, Gerrie Gait. Gerrie with the save. Gerrie Gait to Gerrie. That's kind of tough to...
It gets confusing, but Gerrie, G-E-R-R-I-E, Gerrie made the great save right in front, and that's where the shot's been coming from, Craig, right in front of the goalie, Gerrie. He's made about four sensational saves to keep that score at 1-1.
Bandits work it in. O'Hanlon having trouble controlling the ball. Taken off the play by Dan Pratt. Dan Pratt had his helmet taken off.
Dan Pratt, All-American defenseman at Syracuse University. What a program Roy Simmons has up there. He is such an athlete, he comes down here and plays for Medo Martinello. But watch the physical play in there. Pratt, All-American defenseman, racks him into the boards, keeps going and gets the helmet knocked off. They stop play to get it back in place.
A ball bouncing in to the bench will give the ball to the Bandits.
Because both of these teams are north as far as the geographical area of the United States is concerned, Craig, they are both loaded with Canadian-style players. A lot of great stick work, behind-the-back feeds, and in-close shooting.
Brian Hall gets it eventually to Veltman. Shot taken by Keenan from the outside. Sawicki is there. Sawicki might as well be a brick wall.
Keenan again, 17 goals. We talked about him in the open. Tremendous player, leads with Kilgour in the offensive category. The shot comes in, almost gets underneath in the five hole between the legs. We call the five hole beyond Sawicki, but he dives in. Shots in the first quarter, just about dead even.
Nikula's shot went behind the crease. Peter Parke back there, ball is loose in the crease. Very dangerous situation. As Terry Martinello with a cross check to Emick that jarred the ball loose, but Gerrie was back there to get the ball behind the goal.
Looks like Medo Martinello, this is the line I talked about, the key line, I think, for Detroit. Martinellos are playing with Park and Nikula, a very explosive line with some holes because of the speed of the Martinellos.
Bandits have to hurry with only two on the shot clock. The shot taken right at the horn, and that's a 30-second violation.
Don't get me wrong, the Martinellos can score as good as anybody. They still have most of the team scoring records on this team.
Nikula right in front of the goal. Gerrie comes out once again, and Nikula doing his best to get the ball away from Gerrie. Pushing will be the call. The violation gives the ball to the Bandits of Buffalo.
You see the explosive style of Gerrie. Gerrie is playing defense anywhere within 5 yards of the goal. He's coming back and making the big hits. The Detroit players won't forget that when they get in range, they're going to get rocked. And that is going to pay dividends for Gerrie later in the game.
Buff McCready, the coach of the Bandits. Bandits on the attack here, 18 on the shot clock, as this is Brian Hall. To Kevin Alexander, the Hall of Famer, behind the back pass, stolen away. Turbos on the counterattack. Ron Martinello. There's Terry Martinello. Quick pass. The deke by Brian Lemon, but that one won't go through.
That was my point. Ronnie Martinello and Terry both don't have great speed, but look at the stick work. They moved it up very quickly. Ronnie went to Terry. Terry had a tremendous feed across, and the shot just went high.
4 minutes to go. We're still tied at one in the first quarter, and we expected an offensive showdown, and it's become a defensive matchup. Keenan tries the shot. It won't go. Emick tries to corral the ball. Lemon up to Paul Gait. One-on-one against Gerrie, and Paul Gait whiffs on the shot, amazingly.
Well, if we see that ball, that replay at some point, Craig, I think you'll see the ball come out of his stick before he shot. To my eyes, that ball left his stick before he took the shot. Consequently, he didn't get it. Otherwise, that's a goal. Let's take a look. Here he comes down. See if it doesn't leave the stick early. He does a couple different fakes. The ball comes up high. You see that? It rolled off the inside lip, left his stick before he shot.
You're going to talk about the construction of the sticks at halftime.
We have a little bit there that'll tell you about the intricacies of each player who cater to the absolute shooting tendencies of each stick. They put shooting strings in them, they get the stick, they shrink it down to their own personal size. Very, very, very personal taste for each player.
We're going to take a break, back with more on the Game of the Week on Prime Network.
And, of course, one of the keys to the game, I feel, for Buffalo is to win this first quarter.
Their Park couldn't control it. Ball.
We've had a penalty-free game, but right now we've got a player going into the box, and that's Meridian. Meridian goes in for Buffalo. This is another key for the Detroit team specifically. They normally foul more than any other team, looking at Medo Martinello. Here, they are penalty-free so far in this game. So Buffalo goes into the box first, and they may get a chance to get the first goal. That's Bill Fox, referee in his rookie year in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. Big chance. Now, don't forget, Craig, we've seen a lot of teams in the Indoor League score man down. So this is an equally dangerous chance if they lose the ball for Detroit.
Terry Martinello trying to get it in for Gerrie Gait. The pass was too hard, and Gerrie sending it long, looking for Tavares. Tavares has to hustle in the corner. Sawicki is out of the crease, and a crunching blow down there by Ron Martinello.
Ronnie did a good job of chasing him down. Now Tavares is off by himself. He's got the ball, but here's the crunch. Ronnie, great foot speed. He's got a tremendously hurt knee, a knee that was operated on last couple seasons, so his speed was taken away when that knee was operated on, but he chased Tavares down. Meanwhile, shot came in, it went into the goal, but a crease violation, I think, kept that goal from counting. They're even in that score. Game still 1-1, power play Detroit.
Power play continues, but Detroit having trouble getting shots off. Finally, a shot off by Ron Martinello. Terry Martinello off the rebound. Centering pass to Peter Parke. 2 seconds on the shot clock, and it will be a 30-second violation on a power play situation with 55 seconds to go in the quarter, 1:10 in the penalty.
The shot clock at 30, you can't just shoot. You've got to hit the 4 by 4.5 foot goal to reset the shot clock, and they didn't do it.
Holding the call as Derek Keenan was in a one-on-two situation. And the Bandits will get the ball with a new 30 with 47 seconds in the quarter.
Both of these teams lead the league in most of the offensive categories, but as far as shooting and hitting the goal on your shot, on most of your shots, Buffalo does it better than Detroit. Once you hit the goal, Detroit is more accurate.
Buffalo doing a beautiful job killing the penalty. 5 on the shot clock as the ball is centered. Terry Martinello with the interception. Gerrie Gait streaking down, takes the shot, it goes high. Paul Gait fighting for the rebound along with Veltman. Pile up in front of the crease.
Break for Buffalo. Martinello did a great job of picking that one out of the sky, and Buff McCready knows he got away with one there. That was a fast break caused by a lack of concentration on the offensive end.
The Turbos and the Bandits after one quarter, 1-1. Is this the right game?
Sports South and Prime Network. Together, we bring you the best in sports.
The Major Indoor Lacrosse League is happy to offer you a chance to win a trip to the 1992 MILL World Championship game.
Well, Craig, your prize package will include 2 round-trip tickets courtesy of U.S. Air, ground transportation, hotel accommodations, 2 tickets to this prestigious event, and the game's going to be held in early April at a site to be determined.
To enter, send your a postcard with your name, your address, phone number to MILL Flyaway, 9200 Ward Parkway, Suite 500, Kansas City, Missouri, 64114, or call the number on your screen, 1-900-226-MILL, $2 per minute. 1-1 as we go into quarter number 2. Ted Sawicki behind the goal in a matchup, trying to keep it away from Mike Meridian. Tavares gets a shot away, right in front of the goal, shot to score by the Hall of Famer, Kevin Alexander.
Alexander, big goal by Alexander. Here's the veteran. He's not going to beat you on physical strength. He's a small guy, and he's really being outrun by these younger players, but he's in the right place at the right time. Look at the stick skills. Pulls the stick back, makes one fake to the near side, goes to the far corner. Nobody is smarter on the field of play in lacrosse than Kevin Alexander. Fakes the inside, goes to the far corner when he just had a small corner to shoot at. I'm going to show you his stick at halftime and show you how accurate he can shoot because of the construction and the time he puts into personalizing his stick. Kevin Alexander.
9 goals this year for the veteran rookie. He's a rookie in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League.
He's in the Hall of Fame in Canada. He's 35.
Once again, a quick shot and a score! Jim Bissell playing in only his 4th game this year.
We have to watch. Sawicki may be yanked early in this game because Medo will not hesitate going to Sammut. But watch the fast break on the faceoff. They come down, get it right up. Hiltz gets it to the streaking Bissell, and Bissell goes right into the 5-hole between the legs. You can see Sawicki was not set. Watch him moving right to left. He was back on his heels. He didn't expect a fast break off the faceoff. It rarely happens. Craig, this team from Buffalo has dominated faceoffs ever since Alexander got there, and it's paying dividends here in the second quarter.
Fans here at the Joe Louis Arena are stunned. 3-1 the score. And a shot by Darris Kilgour almost made it 4-1.
2 goals in the first minute of the second quarter.
Darris Kilgour with another shot point blank. Fighting for it, Bissell. Along with Jack Sebastian for the Turbos.
It'll be interesting to see how long Medo goes with Sawicki. Sawicki is a first-team All-Pro. There's nobody better. But Sammut is so good on the bench. Last week against Baltimore, big game. They didn't hesitate. They started Sammut, went to Sawicki, went back to Sammut. Both teams, 2 good goalies, and they won't hesitate to go to either of them.
Hiltz looking for the centering pass. Takes it up top. Tavares with a shot wide. Kilgour comes up with a ball behind the goal. Darris Kilgour loses control of it. Ball loose at the restraining line. Bissell comes away with it.
That was a great chance of why a stick might cause you to lose control. Remember that check you just saw? Because at halftime, I'll show you why that ball might not leave Kilgour's stick if he had a smaller stick. Wait for the halftime for that. But look at the first quarter stats, and they look pretty even. Shots on goal, though. The Bandits controlling it 12-7. Most of those 19 shots for both teams right in the face of these goalies. I think the goalies, Craig, had a sensational first quarter.
The shots on goal by the Bandits, 12 out of 13 on goal. What an excellent percentage, and the Turbos having trouble getting anywhere near that.
We talked about that in the first quarter, how they are the most accurate team in the league as far as shooting, hitting the goal. Whether they get it in or not, that's where Detroit has a better number. But they'll get it on goal. They will test the goalie on most shots.
The Turbos now having to play catch-up lacrosse. Not something that they're used to. This is Mueller in the corner to Ron Martinello for Peter Park. At 6'5", he can come at you from all sorts of ways, but couldn't put it in there.
Last game they played 11 times. Detroit came back and answered goals by the Buffalo team. 65% of the times it was the Gates that answered the call. Let's see if they can do it here in Detroit.
Maybe not. Shot and a goal, number 2 of the night for Bob Hamley. As there you see the frustrating ball inside the net.
I talked about somebody having a maiden hat trick. It could be Hamley. Here's a guy who might step forward and have the big game when they need it. He comes in right in the face of Sawicki, finds the corner. Sawicki a little bit off his game now because he's had a lot of shots right in his face. Here we are again to see it in the first 2.5 minutes, 3 goals on Sawicki. But Hamley could be the guy we talked about having that maiden hat trick to really lift Buffalo to the next level.
In the first 15 minutes of play, it was 1-1. In the last 2 minutes and 30 seconds, it's 3-0 Buffalo.
They've taken over the second quarter, and that's why I thought the first quarter was so key, Craig, because the confidence level of this team, although it's high now, they needed to stay in the game in the first quarter so they can get back on their legs and continue the offensive onslaught that they put into this league in the last 3 games.
Gerrie Gait having to go against Derek Keenan. A save by Gerrie. The whistle blows, and
The call will be on Keenan. And the thing that Buffalo did this game that they didn't do last game is they're matching up against the Gates. Keenan and Veltman are going to try to match up. They're going to try to put those two guys on top of Paul and Gary. Keenan that time got called right over there, right there, number 45, got called for wrapping up the Gate brothers a little too tightly. But this is a matchup that's paid dividends so far. Now look, Gary beats him. Keenan is wrapping him up on right side, wrapping him up on the left side. He gets called 2 minutes for that. But so far in the game, the Veltman-Keenan defense has worked.
The Martinellos, the Gates, and Peter Parke make up the power play unit. Successful this time.
Terry Martinello. He is a tremendous shooter. Don't take that away from him. This guy has the accuracy of anybody in the league. Watch Terry get the ball. He's got a tremendously accurate stick. Nobody plays defense against him. And boom, he just finds the corner against Gerrie. So Martinello now answers the call. We talked about the Gates in the first game. Answered the call 65% of the time when they had Buffalo scoring. This time it's Terry Martinello on a power play to give them within 2-4.
That took 9 seconds once the power play started. And now the matchup at the center circle. Gary Gait against Kevin Alexander for the faceoff.
Kevin Alexander in orange taught Gary Gait all the things he knows about facing off. He coached him as a junior player in Canada.
How does the old saying go? You don't teach everything to your students?
I think that's true. Gary Gait and Paul Gait have developed things that they've introduced in the game themselves, but Kevin Alexander got him off on a good foot.
Derek Keenan trying to get around Brian Lemon. Holding the call, we're gonna take a break. 11:37 to go, 4-2 Buffalo. Welcome back to the Joe Louis Arena. 2 goals for the Bandits.
We left you at 4-2, and look at this. A long outlet pass by Gary to the veteran, Kevin Alexander. He pulls it in. It's all Kevin Alexander against Sawicki. He makes the no-fake move. Once to the right, once to the left, beats Sawicki. That made it 5-2. Then Emmett gets the ball way out in front. Sawicki has to move to center. He's unsettled, and he gets beat for another goal, 6-2. I don't think Medo Martinello is going to let Sawicki stay in very long, Craig. If it stays like this, look at that. Alexander, Emick, and the last two scores. Sawicki is on his last legs. If it continues like this, Medo Martinello won't hesitate to go to Mike Sammut in the goal.
A little more than halfway through the second quarter, 6-2 Buffalo. Gary Gait trying to make it 6-3. He can't do it. And the Bandits just shutting down from the outside. Finneran trying to get it to Gary Gait. 30-second violation of the call.
You can see how the matchups have really worked well. Veltman and Keenan have locked up the Gait brothers. They have been no factor so far. Look at that hitting in there. In the scoring, it's only been Nikula and Terry Martinello. The Gaits have not dented the nets in the first quarter and a half. And don't forget, they had 13 goals, Craig, in the first game between these two teams.
Including a record 8 goals by Paul Gait. Meridian tried to get it up to Bob Hamley. Sawicki comes out of the crease. You know, there's a lot of frustration going through the mind of Ted Sawicki right now. Here's Paul Gait. Gait behind the crease, loses control of the ball, and Gerrie will haul it in.
Buffalo trying to match up with the Gates this time, not letting them command. We talked about our keys to keep them down to 9 or less. 9 is their league average. Last time they had 13. If Buffalo keeps them under the league average, they've got a great chance to win the game.
Centering pass as O'Hanlon tries the shot. Sawicki with the bounce pass. Here comes John Hamilton for the Turbos.
Ryan Nikula came in on the substitution. He was ready to take the pass. He had a defender underneath him, but he's a good guy to go to on a transition.
Peter Parke with the ball at the restraining line. Over to Nikula. Into the corner for Mueller. Mueller to the middle of the field inside of Parke, but he loses control of the ball.
Parke had the ball where he could have shot. He is hearing footsteps because of the aggressive defense that Buffalo has put on in the first quarter. They said coming into this game, we're going to wrap up Parke, make him think about it. He was thinking about getting hit when he took that pass, didn't get it cleanly.
Gerrie Hiltz wrapped up by Mueller. Ball loose on the field. And we may see a penalty here or at the the very least holding. Yeah, and holding will be the call against Buffalo.
Greg, both teams, well, here we go, some fast, fast breaking action.
Very quickly, Nikula with a shot. It won't go in. One more time.
Here's the last hit out in front. Look at that. Mueller just takes him down. He'll miss on that shot, but he'll go back with a wraparound. And here's Park getting wrapped up. We'll get Nikula into Park. Now, this is when he could have had the shot. See that? He didn't look at the ball all the way. When you're on that crease area, you're going to get hit. That's the way Buffalo's been playing him, and he was thinking about the contact before the ball got there.
Tavares with a pass to Darris Kilgour. Tavares at the point. His shot wide to the left side. Ball loose inside the crease. Sawicki will pick it up. But Darris Kilgour had a stick in there trying to get it away from him.
Great game plan so far for Buffalo. They haven't had the Gait brothers any factor. They're no factor in the scoring so far.
Gerrie Gait plants himself in front of the net. Tried the underhand shot, but Gerrie was there.
That defensive line, Bissell wrapped him up that time, and now Gerrie gets the outlet. Fresh line in for Buffalo. The offensive legs are on there. Now a tired defense for Detroit. Let's see if Buffalo can take advantage of it. Whole new line in there, Craig.
Alexander with a shot from the outside. Follow-up, Veltman. That one won't go through. Long pass, Sawicki to Paul Gait. Paul Gait wrapped up in front, puts the shot down, but look how Gerrie got the stick down and just parried it, not over the crossbar, over the net.
Well, those are two Hall of Fame saves. It started on the other end with this guy, Sawicki. Watch the saves, one right in the face, this one with the arm. Tremendous saves, he gets it in his stick. Then on the other end of the field, another Hall of Fame save by by Gerrie. This is Paul Gait. This is normally 9 times out of 10 gonna be a goal. But Gerrie comes up, just sweeps it away, makes the save. Those three saves were sensational by each goalie, and the score remains 6-2, Buffalo.
There you get a good look at Paul Gait.
Frustration right there. The Gates, no factor so far. Paul Gait, you mentioned it 100 times, 8 goals in the first matchup. Right there, 26 goals, leads the league coming into this game. These guys can explode at any moment, but if you take them out of the game for 2 quarters, I say your chances are pretty good.
We may see... I thought we might see a change in goalies,
it might be a penalty shot. It's going to be a penalty shot against Gerrie because that was a flagrant foul. It's going to be, I believe, a penalty shot with Pete Park taking it down one-on-one with Gerrie. Medo Martinello has chosen Pete Park for the penalty shot.
Pete Park at 6'5", 225. Here he goes. Past the restraining line. Deeks, but the shot will not go.
I got to tell you, I have not seen Detroit. I'm giving credit to Buffalo. We have all first 2 quarters, but Craig, I haven't seen Detroit miss the goal as many times as they've missed it tonight. They are constantly missing with shots just like this. There's no excuse for missing the goal. He comes down. Peter, look at him put his head back. He missed the 4x4.5. He'll take the shot. He's got the whole goal to shoot at, and he just puts it too high. His head goes back in anguish. All during the first 2 quarters of this game, the Gates, Park, all the big shooters have been missing the goal more often than they do during the season.
You've had a chance to travel around now 6 years. Watching the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. You've seen the Turbo since their inception. Have you ever seen them have as much trouble as they're having tonight since the Gates have arrived?
Not since the Gates have arrived. And, of course, 2 years ago they had trouble scoring. There you go, another big score by Buffalo.
Emick, and that is that maiden hat trick you were talking about.
Could be Emick, it could be Hamley. Emick's got two now, but I was looking for somebody to come up and shine. It could be Emick, it could be Hamley, but they're going to do it for me. Here they go. Buffalo comes down, fast break. Emick gets it, makes the big fake, and beats Sawicki to the far corner. Medo Martinello's got a tough job now, Craig, because he's got to figure out how long do you go with Sawicki. He's been first team all pro for many years. Here again, the fast break over to Emick, all by himself. Sawicki comes out to cut the angle, but Emick finds the far pipe. How long do you go with the guy who's taken you to the championship last year? That is Medo Martinello's challenge right now. The score 7-2.
Unbelievable. 4:35 to go in the half. John Hamilton for the Turbos to Dan Pratt. Pratt being checked and checked hard by Hamlin. Up top to Sebastian.
I started to talk about the offense. The question you asked me, Craig, Detroit has had the shots in this game. They just have not been hitting the goal. It's one of those nights. That's something that Medo would fear, any coach fears every night, that you'll have one of those nights where your great offensive people are just going to miss the goal. I think they've done that a half a dozen times tonight where normally they wouldn't do it. They've had the shots, though.
Meridian tried to get it up to Hamley, stolen away by Dan Pratt. And away from the ball, a little bit of a pushing match. We're going to take a break, 7-2 Buffalo.
I'm Rick Sowell of the Baltimore Thunder, and I'm going to score a bunch of goals tonight.
We'll see about that, and you can see it on the Mill Home video.
This exciting video is full of the greatest action from the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. To order, send a cashier's check or money order for $9.95. That's right, only $9.95 plus $3 postage and handling to Mill Home Video, 9200 Ward Parkway, Suite 500, Kansas City, Missouri, 64114. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery.
We know.
Little less than 2 minutes to go in the half. 7-2, a power play opportunity here for the Buffalo Bandits after a game misconduct called on Dan Pratt.
And an ejection. He's out of the game. You won't see Danny Pratt anymore.
Here's Keenan behind the back pass. Tavares, point blank shot, puts it in for goal number 8.
Buffalo's threatening to make this an ugly game for the home crowd. You hear the boos spattering through. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 goals of their 8 in the second quarter. Watch the great ball movement behind the back feed. Tavares all by himself fakes Sawicki to the near pipe, hits the second pipe. I'm surprised that Medo has gone this long with Teddy. Teddy's a great goalie, but he's not having a night. The second quarter is killing his team. They may be out of it if he doesn't get him out of there soon. Big fake there. He looks to the near pipe and hits the far twine. Great move by Tavares, who was a sensational shooter in the Canadian leagues. 9th goal this season, but let me tell you, he shot about 56 shots coming into this game. He's got a lot of assists, Craig, but in Canada, he would score in bunches. He just hasn't found the right formula for this fast Major Indoor Lacrosse League. He's a guy that could really come on and be an all-pro in this league.
Buff McCready calls timeout for his team, and you don't suppose that he just wants to come over and go, guys, you're doing well.
I tell you, there you are doing sensationally. You got that 5-goal lead. He's really holding his breath to make sure they hold that going into the halftime. 1:33 left, but I would suspect that you'll see Sammut in the second half for Detroit. You'll see a fired-up Gait brother combination trying to work on the big defense that Buffalo put on them. The key to me is the fact that they put Veltman and Keenan to seal off the Gait brothers and have kept them out of the offense.
In case you're wondering, a little historical perspective. Last year, the only two losses by the Turbos, 19-13 and 17-15, both to New York. We're not talking blowouts here.
Well, don't forget, this is an expansion team. Buffalo, if they win tonight, they've got more than a good chance, a fair chance, if somebody else can knock off Detroit, and if the playoff structure changes, of going into the playoffs. Let's take a look at the offensive efficiency of the Detroit squad. Remind you that this team, this is a power rating system that I came up with coming into this game. This rates the amount of shots against the goals scored. You see Kilgour, Keenan, very efficient. Hilt's efficient. Paul and Gary Gait, efficient, but Gary's taking a lot of shots, so he's down to +1. Ronnie and Terry Martinello, they're taking only too many shots for the amount of goals scored. They're -2, -5 on my power rating. Pete Parke +4, Armando Rodriguez +2. What that shows you is that Martinello, Ronnie and Terry, are not getting the effective offense going. That right now, because they are such a key offense, is hurting the Detroit team.
Paul Gay trying to get some offensive power, but once again, he whiffs on a shot. Unbelievable for Paul Gay. This is Gary Gait. His shot nowhere near the 4x4.5. And if the Turbos aren't careful, they're going to see a fast break the other way. Tavares slows it down because it was a 1-on-4 situation. Keenan with a bounce pass to the far side. 50 seconds to go in the quarter.
And now we've got the major. The time has changed for the Pratt penalty to more than 5 minutes.
Well, I believe it was a game misconduct, which would be a 10-minute penalty, wouldn't it?
They didn't have it on the boards, which confuses me, so they changed that marking. Now it's at 4:53.
Hamley with a shot. Pat saves Sawicki. We might get a clarification, but it might have been a two-minute penalty followed by a five-minute penalty, which would make sense.
We'll just tell you what we see. We see 4 minutes, 41 seconds up there for Pratt. Look at Sawicki on the ground. Tommy Young ready to blow the game back in.
I think the ball may have gone down into the big britches that he wears for padding.
They all wear a lot of pads. 17 seconds left. Detroit's got to go ahead and take a shot.
This is Paul Gait. He takes the shot. Save Gerrie. And the half will end with a Buffalo 8-2 lead. The official blows the whistle, and a two-minute penalty will be called here, possibly against the Detroit Turbos with 0.4 seconds to go on the clock, and it will be called against Brian Nikula.
Well, Keenan has the ball. He's going to have to shoot. Less than a second, less than a half a second. He'll just have to shoot to end the first half.
He takes the shot, and the half will end 8-2.
Well, when they come back in the second half, they're going to have 2 men in the box for the Turbos. Boy, Buffalo has everything going their way. Look at Medo. He's going to have a tough halftime.
Coors Light halftime report coming up, including a very special feature on sticks and the way they're shaped and used by Leif Elsbaum.
This more severe.
Buick's pursuit of quality never ends.
I agree with that. We're going to make it even tougher.
We need to go in with higher speeds, higher coring loads.
Because it's not perfect till it's Buick perfect.
But it's not good enough for what we want to do. So let's go with 23% hill, maximum
quality that lasts.
The anti-lock brakes allow
even after a year of use, no domestic car maker is more trouble-free than Buick.
Great work. You sure you don't want us to run some more tests?
With 99 models redesigned and engineered, GM is putting quality on the
lacrosse is America's fastest growing and most exciting sport. For all your lacrosse needs, it's Allman Sports International. Allman has the best in protective equipment. Custom sticks with exclusive Allman pockets. The latest t-shirts, team jerseys, shorts, jackets, and a full line of officials gear. Allman Sports International has everything you need to play your best and look great doing it. For a free catalog, call 1-800-BESTICK.
Baseball's most intimidating weapon. The home run. The power. The glory. Major League Baseball Home Video and the Sporting News have created a new video, the 50 greatest home runs in baseball history, and it's absolutely free with your paid subscription. The myth makers, the record breakers, they're all here, and they're all yours when you subscribe to the Sporting News at this amazing price only through this TV offer. So call this toll-free number and order the Sporting News now. The Sporting News brings you the most comprehensive baseball coverage anywhere, all year long. And only the Sporting News brings you great year-round coverage of football, basketball, and hockey, too. Remember, the 50 greatest home runs in baseball history is available only through the Sporting News. So call and start your subscription now.
Craig Johnson back with you on the Coors Light Halftime Report. The Buffalo Bandits with a surprising 8-2 lead over the defending champion Detroit Turbos. Before the game, Leif Elsbaum had an opportunity to take a look at the science of lacrosse sticks. Let's join Leif Elsbaum right now.
I don't think any piece of equipment is more important to an athlete than the lacrosse stick is to a lacrosse player. Now, they all look the same to us, but really they're quite different. Look at this stick used by Gary and Paul Gait. These guys have revolutionized the game with their offense. They use an STX Turbo. They shrink it down in the oven and make the pocket a little tighter so they get a lot of control going through traffic and all those checks don't have the ball popping out. They put 3 shooting strings made of lace at the top of the stick to give the ball a smooth path coming out. This makes their shot accurate. Each player does a different personal style of shooting string. Contrast that with Darris Kilgour's stick. This is Darris Kilgour's Superlight 2 made by Brine. It's not it's not as thick a wall. It doesn't stand as high. Consequently, the pocket isn't as deep. Look how wide Darris Kilgour's stick is. When he is in traffic, this ball is bouncing around, very tough to control, yet he leads his team in scoring. Two other sticks I want to show you will be these sticks. One is Jack Sebastian's, who uses a mesh stick. The mesh gives you an instant pocket, very, very soft, easy to control the ball, good for ground balls, etc. He's not an offensive player per se. He likes to get control, and he does get it with this mesh stick. Three shooting strings made of nylon, one of lace underneath it. You can see the path of the ball for Jack is right through there. Always the same spot gives him accuracy. This is Alexander, Kevin Alexander's stick, one of the greatest players to ever play in Canada. Look at this stick. Not very wide at all. The disadvantage of that, like the Gates, is that when you catch it, you have to be accurate because you have to get the ball in there. Once it's in there, very tough to dislodge it. He uses shooting strings that are higher, and the key for Kevin Alexander is that he is a face-off specialist. When you're facing off against this stick, because it's very shallow from here to here, not very high, he has an advantage to get the clamp underneath your stick. He gets control, thereby a lot more face-offs go Kevin Alexander's way than might go the other way. Some of the intricacies of sticks in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League.
We'll be back with more of the Coors Light Halftime Report in just a moment.
Because you believe these trucks shouldn't carry a spare tire.
It's a ride beer now.
Because up here, crisp-tasting beer just comes naturally.
It's a ride beer now.
Because when the whole gang gets together, there's no room for filling up. So reach for the silver bullet, the beer that won't weigh you down.
It's a ride beer now.
Show you our corporate offices. You see, we don't wear three-piece suits, nor do we wear wingtip shoes. And you sure won't find oak panel walls, but what you will find is the liveliest softball bat you can buy, because at DeMarini Custom Bats, only three things count: distance, distance, and distance. So if you're ready for the ultimate softball bat, your custom DeMarini bat is ready for you. Please call now to order.
Step up to the plate with softball's ultimate weapon. The DeMarini Custom Bat. Cutting-edge design, high-tech space-age alloy, unmatched performance. To order your DeMarini Custom Bat or for a free brochure, call 800-937-BATS today.
Back on the Coors Light Halftime Report. 8-2, the big number, but let's take a look at some of the, quote, little numbers.
Well, interestingly enough, the total shots are about even. Shots on goal, Bandits still with a commanding lead, 12 in that category. Faceoffs, Turbos lead by one, but let's take a look at the scoring leaders for the Turbos. The absence of the Gates, that's the big thing. You got Nikula and Martinello, Terry with a goal apiece. That ain't much scoring. That's about 2 minutes of scoring for these guys normally. Kevin Alexander with two, the veteran at 35 years old. Then Hamley, who comes in with nine goals, gets two. Emmick came in with one goal. He's got two. He could be our maiden hat trick that really brings this team up another level.
Will the Bandits be flying away to the championship? You might be able to, including two round-trip tickets courtesy of U.S. Air Ground Transportation, hotel accommodations, and two tickets to the prestigious event. There's the address on your screen, 9200 Ward Parkway, Suite 500, Kansas City, Missouri, or you can enter by phone, 1-900-226-MILL, $2 per minute. Speaking of flying away, at halftime, the bungee jumper. He goes way down, and then he comes back up. Will the Turbos be able to come back? We'll find out when we return on Prime Network.
Baltimore Thunder, and I'm going to score a bunch of goals tonight.
We'll see about that, and you can see it on the Mill home video.
Half a play as Buffalo with a 6-goal lead, and the ball to start half number two. Ted Sawicki still in goal for the Turbos.
Greg, I'm going to second guess Medo Martinello on that. You've got a power play here, 5-on-3. Maybe that's why he doesn't want to break Samut's iron here of confidence, but I'm going to second-guess Medo Martinello. When you come out in the second half, I think you want a fresh start after a terrible second quarter. You got to change the goalie, start with that, and then look for your Gait brothers to start the offense going.
A 5-on-3 situation due to a penalty that happened just before the end of the half and that game misconduct to Dan Pratt, which turned out to be a minor penalty and a major penalty put together. Gary Gait with a shot, Paul Gait off the rebound, 3 on the shot clock. He won't be able to get a shot away, but that's quite effective, taking 30 seconds off the 5-on-3 situation.
They did a great job. That's all they want to do. I was surprised they took the shots they did, but they are a confident bunch, the Gait brothers are. Now they're coming down. It's only 5-on-2 right now, 3-on-2, but when they get settled, if they get settled, it'll be 5-on-3. No, the Gates get the ball back. Terrible mistakes by Buffalo. They can put this game away right here, but they're taking the chance away from themselves.
Gary Gait trying to catch up to the ball after it was stick-checked away by Keenan. Alexander with a lead pass. Here's Tavares. He can't get the shot away. 27 on the second penalty.
Well, Buffalo really has been horrendous with the two-man advantage. They have totally blown it so far. 17, 16, 15 seconds left on the one penalty. They'll still have 2 minutes plus with a man up, but they're taking away the chance to put the nails in the coffin.
Peter Parke with a super short-handed goal. Off the feed from Paul Gait, 8-3. And that is what you just call good stick work.
Park does a nice job of coming in there and putting that one away in close range. He is so dangerous in there. You saw there was no defense on him. Look at Pete Park on the bench. If I was Buff McCready, I'd call a timeout and shake my team up. They come out with a big lead, a 6-goal lead, a 2-man advantage, and they blow it. They give up a goal. This is critical. Medo Martinello's got to be ecstatic. But Buff McCready's team has thrown away a golden opportunity to absolutely close off the chance of a comeback.
6 seconds remaining on the 5-on-3 situation. Pat Lee on the faceoff. Faceoff won, however, by the Bandits. Shot, score, Tavares off the nice feed by Hall.
Tavares gets it back, so obviously Buffalo feels good. Tavares' second goal in a row. He got the last one of the second quarter, and he starts the scoring here. Nice movement on the faceoff, comes in and beats Sawicki right along the pipe. Just above the hip, tough place for the goalies to make a save. Right down there along the hip area, that's where the good shooters aim. And 9-3 now, and still, no, that wipes out that penalty, right, Greg? We're all leaving. 5-on-5 right now.
That the second goal scored, so that allows the player to be released on a major penalty. Darris Kilgour trying to fight his way through, and Sawicki will stay in the goal.
I can't understand that. All Medo Martinello does is talk about how great Sammut has played here.
Look at Gerrie.
Being chased around, but really not much of a challenge there. They're wasting a lot of energy playing defense down there because now they got to race all the way back and then suck it up and play tough defense against Buffalo.
Meridian against Ron Martinello tries to power it in there. Holding the call, Buffalo will get the ball back.
I was talking about Craig. Medo talks about how great Sammut is and how they don't mind going with him. Sawicki has been an all-pro, no question, but he had a terrible second quarter. You got to go ahead if you have faith in your second guy and get it. Now watch Sawicki here come up, fill up the goal, and make the big save. Tough defense by Park.
The Bandits with 20 on the shot clock, having trouble controlling it. Here's Meridian right in front of the goal. Pass right into the stands.
Ouch.
Trying to get it to Bill O'Hanlon, and
did he
hold on to the beer?
Oh, man, that went right in the old popcorn basket there. Hopefully that fan was watching. Fresh line in for Detroit.
This is Paul Gait, who came out during halftime and warmed up on his own.
Don't forget the last game, Paul Gait had 8 goals himself. No Gait goals so far.
Gerrie from the point. Gerrie pulls it in. Long pass. And Keenan is there, but Sawicki takes it away from him.
Sawicki being aggressive, good move by him, and his outlet pass, nobody does it better than he does.
Here's Gerrie Gait, fakes the shot, goes too far to the right with it. Finneran to John Lancey, the rookie, against Paul Day.
Keenan, or Veltman, got a stick on that, knocked it back to Gerrie. Tremendous defense by that man with the ball, Veltman, and his sidekick in this matchup, Keenan. Keenan and Veltman have put the wraps on the Gait brothers like nobody else in this league has for the last 2 years.
10:51 to go, third quarter, 9-3 Buffalo. Finneran on the counterattack, across the restraining line. His shot, a pad save on the arm, courtesy of Bill Gerrie.
Bill Gerrie is looking sharp. He feels great. He's got the big pad in lead, 9-6.
Alexander to Veltman. Veltman holding on to the ball despite the defense of Pat Lee. Flips it back for the trailer.
Bounces off the pipe. Good pipe save for Sawicki.
We'll take a break. 9-3 Buffalo.
Great leg.
The roar you hear is for the Turbos as we return you to the Joe Louis Arena. Peter Parke with his second goal.
Second straight goal. Peter Parke trying to pick up the slack. Nikula gets the loose ball, finds Parke on the crease, and there he goes, just wheels around. Most of the game, Buffalo has been laying on Parke, really wrapping him up. He was free that time. One time earlier, we saw him miss that feed. This time, he collects it, gets the good shot, 9-4. If I'm Medo Martinello, Craig, I want to be back to within 3 when the fourth quarter starts. That's all, just back to within 3. He's got 9-5. He's got 2 more goals to make up in this quarter to feel pretty comfortable.
The face-off at the center circle, Kevin Alexander against Gerrie Gait.
The teacher against the pupil. Alexander taught them as junior players all the techniques of facing off. Alexander playing for multiple world teams for Canada in lacrosse.
Ball kicked around. Nobody has been able to pick it up as Veltman on the one touch back to Gerrie. At midfield, this is Kevin Alexander for the Bandits. The Hall of Famer with a shot and a score.
Tremendous play by the veteran Alexander. What he did was moved to an open area to give Gerrie an outlet. And once he got the ball, he took it all the way up. Here he is. He moved all the way over across the field just to get in that open area. Once he gets it, he sees nobody's playing defense, so he's off to the run. The sloppy check misses him on both sides. You're going to have to run him down, but you can't stay behind him. Since nobody got in front of him, you can stop him at 35 by getting in front of him, but playing behind him, he's too smart. He comes in, Gerrie Gait slides too late, and he bounces it past Sawicki. 10-4, and I don't know why Mike Sammut is not in the game. Alexander's third goal, his hat trick. He's a veteran, not the maiden hat trick that we're looking for in keys of the game. Although he may not have had a hat trick this year, which would qualify him, wouldn't it? We want to look good on the keys of the game, folks. So maybe I'll have to ask him. If he doesn't have a hat trick, he'll qualify, and we'll look good in the keys of the game.
Your reputation depends
on it.
At
stake, no question about it. But why, I have to find out. You know, I'm just second-guessing Medo. Where here you got Mike Sammut, who's playing sensationally this year, on the bench. And obviously, Sawicki not having a great game.
Gerrie hauling it in. And Paul Day will bring it down. This is Darris Kilgour in midfield.
I want to mention Kilgour does not have a score yet this game either. He had led this team with 17 goals coming in, along with Keenan.
Hiltz moving to the inside, takes a shot and a score.
Well, I think Mito's got to make a move. I keep saying it, but what's he waiting for? Here he is. Sawicki absolutely riddled. No confidence left in this all-pro goalie. Watch Hiltz come in. Tremendous player in my power ranking in offense. Hiltz is a plus five. He doesn't shoot that much, but when he does, a lot of chances to get a goal just like that. Great stick working close. 11-4. Here he comes again. One more look. Look at how he dodges the stick around. Finally beats Sawicki. And Samut's coming into the game, and I think Medo Martinello waited about three goals too long. We'll have to see if it makes the big difference. Change in the goal for Medo Martinello.
Sammut back into the
point
Netherlands, I guess you could say.
The point may be Sammut by now. Is that too queer a pun? It's a Sammut point. That's my point. Sammut. He's wearing a field headgear. If it looks a little different to you, that's a field helmet he's more comfortable with as he gets in the goal. Look, Mike Sammut has been sensational, and normally you have that timeout at halftime. And Craig, that's a good chance to get your team in a whole different frame of mind. I think it's a great time to change the goalie. You come out, you play a totally different game. When you tie a guy like Sawicki in there who's been struggling, it doesn't help you at all.
That layoff, the faceoff, going one-on-one against Hiltz, and Hiltz with a cross check. Hiltz is down there. Deitrich, Mahar.
I saw his kids out there before the game. Looks like he had about four or five of them throwing the ball around. Straighten it out. Be back in just a moment. Score 11-4, Buffalo.
A power play goal brought the Turbos within six.
And Paul Gait finally gets on the board. Eight goals last time they met. Here's his first of the game. Nifty juke move to the right side. Pulls a stick back in for the left-handed shot and beats Gerrie for the first time tonight. There it is. Paul Gait at 7:31 in the third. Meanwhile, there's a power play situation for Detroit right now. And Craig, they could not get a pass Gerrie a moment ago. And it's still Buffalo ball now. They're a man short.
As a matter of fact, it is a four-on-four situation because a penalty called against the Bandits. The major penalty to Neil Doddridge that happened about 3 minutes ago still in effect, so it's a four-on-four situation here.
That's right, good point. Two scores against that major before it's released. Doddridge killed his team last year with setting records in this league for penalties. He hasn't played regularly this year and hurts his team in the third quarter here with a major penalty. He jumped into the bench, starts swinging the fists, and that's why he's got the major.
Here's Gerrie Gait, who has yet to score tonight. Hits the post on that one. Keenan tried to get the rebound, but Gerrie Gait is there. The pass to Brother Paul. Over to Gerrie behind the back, and Paul Gait can't find the ball as it bounces off the official. Here's a fast break opportunity. Gerrie Hiltz for the Buffalo Bandits. Score!
Hiltz on the fast break. Sensational. Two in a row for Hiltz. And he is on a roll. He could be our made-in hat trick player. And Hiltz is a great finisher. He's got a tremendous power rating from me of plus five because he doesn't shoot much. But when he does, watch him stick the goal. Second goal in a row. Nifty job for Hiltz. Comes in. Makes Sammut lock himself in the right, and once Sammut commits, or Sammut didn't move much at all, Hiltz finds his target and dashes that baby in there. Seven goal cushion for Buffalo. And you know, that was set up down lower by the Gates passing it back and forth. The pass back behind their back wasn't bad. The last pass, Craig, hit the referee, and it bounced off. It was a little bit behind one of the Gate brothers, but it hit the referee that really took it out of the way and started that fast break.
The lowest scoring output by Detroit this year, 13 goals in a win over New York. And magically, it appears.
Well, this is exactly what Medo was fearing, that he would have a letdown sometime with his twin turbos. These guys carry the team. When you have two guys that constitute about 60% of your offense, Craig, this is what you worry about, because the Gates and Park are the lion's share of the goals scored on the Detroit team.
Buffalo with the possession and a new 30.
The two Gates and Park have 48% of all the shots taken by Detroit. That's a seasonal average.
Scalzo up to Peter Park. His shot from the outside. saved by the arm of Gerrie, but Gerrie doesn't realize he didn't have it to make the pass. Parke picks it up, tried to get it to Mueller. That won't go, and that will lead to a counterattack situation. Here's Keenan, all the way, takes it behind the crease. Out front for Alexander, the juke, the pass, the score, Tavares.
Well, that's the veteran. You can hang that goal on Kevin Alexander. He gets the assist, but believe me, what he left was nothing to defend because he sucked the whole defense into him. Watch the ball come out. Keenan did a nice job of taking it behind the goal. Gets it back to the great Alexander, who makes the big fake. When he draws three defenders, he gives it down to Tavares, and Sammut cannot slide that fast. Watch him draw three defenders. Alexander, once he gets all three defenders on him with a tremendous fake, drops it down to Tavares, who just redirects it past a sliding Sammut. And Medo Martinello is losing control. I think one of the big mistakes he made, and he's a sensational coach, the defending champion coach, is that he put his goalie, his substitute goalie, in there too late. He went too long with the great Ted Sawicki, who just didn't have a fantastic night tonight. But let's go to the offensive side, Craig. What a job Buffalo has done. This is the third time they've met Detroit this year. First time in an exhibition game, they lost by 10. And then during the season, they lost by 5. Tonight, they put it all together.
Winning by 8 with 2:26 to go in quarter number 3. And Buffalo winning the faceoff. Mahar, centering pass intended for Darris Kilgour, reeled in by Bissell. Here's Darris Kilgour. In front, Mahar tried to push it in, couldn't get it through. Bissell picks up the loose ball. Darris Kilgour with 10 seconds and a delayed penalty coming up. Tavares with a shot, and we will see a penalty called against the Turbos with 2:01 to go in quarter number 3.
Looks like, by the way, he's looking. Jack Sebastian's going to go in the box. There he goes. Jack Sebastian really counted on as a ground ball guy, like ground ball line, and he'll set up the offense very well. They don't look for too many goals coming out of Jack, and he gets into the box. Here are the standings, and don't forget now, after this game is not counted in here, of course, but if Buffalo wins, that gives Detroit the two losses. That gives Boston and Buffalo a shot at taking over the division. Didn't take them long, Craig.
Speaking of shots, John Tavares just put another one to the back of the goal.
He parked himself in the same spot. Now, this is a man-up play, a power play. First power play goal, I think, for Buffalo tonight. Detroit was 3-0 in uneven situations before this goal, but Tavares, there's an uncanny pattern here on the Buffalo side of scoring that everybody, all these scorers get two in a row. Emmett got two in a row. Tavares got two in a row. Hiltz got two in a row. And now Tavares gets two in a row again, his fourth goal of the night. Buffalo sideline. Very, very happy with what's going on, as you can imagine.
You sounded like a DJ there with all your two in a rows.
Well, you see how the pattern's uncanny.
The double shot Bandits leading 14-5.
Six to three, they're leading in this quarter.
Gary Gait steals the pass. And you'd have to think that the Gait brothers have to be the spark for any kind of comeback. Here's Kevin Finneran, his shot deflected wide by Gary. Gait with the rebound, that's Gary Gait. Tried to get it inside to Finneran, that ball is stolen away. And here on the counterattack, Derek Keenan. Keenan around Lancey, takes a shot, puts it to the back of the net.
And leaving a bunch of Turbos in his wake. Tremendous job when you get in the open field. Big speed advantage, it looks like, as Keenan puts that one in to the Buffalo squad. Watch him beat two players. Keenan comes down, he looks around the field, makes one big move there, and the wrap check doesn't save him. The other player gets knocked down, and he beats Sammut with a flying check there. It was Lancey who couldn't pick him up. Derek Keenan gets a goal. I think it's first of the night. Wow, 15-5. This game is getting out of reach.
Yep. 15-5 the score. 1:06 to go in the quarter.
Last minute of the play in this quarter.
Last minute of the play, and the crowd applauding. They haven't seen this
in
very much
quarter,
in the last year.
In the third quarter. Talking about the game here, Lee.
And this is a team that really has just run roughshod over the Major Indoor Lacrosse League the last year and a half. Buffalo coming in here to maybe start a new order of power. Nikula likes to sweep down to his left for a left-handed shot.
Peter Parke with a nifty shot. Unfortunately, for him, Bill Gary standing strong. Here's Nikula. His shot goes high. Gerrie going after the ball. Terry Martinello back there, and Gerrie will just flip it. And I think we're going to see a penalty called here.
Well, I'll start with Terry Martinello going after Gerrie, and then to his defense, it was Hamley who came in there to save Gerrie. And Hamley shoved Martinello away, and both of them, I guess, go into the box. Actually, a good play by Terry Martinello, that then Hamley was just protecting his goalie. Gerrie, what a game he's had. He's had the game of the season for him.
And you had mentioned in the last game that we saw the Buffalo Bandits here on Prime Network that he was the man who sparked them.
Well, if you remember, if you watched our Prime Network coverage, it was in Pittsburgh. It was a 6-6 game in Pittsburgh. This was just after they had lost to Detroit the first time. And Gerrie came in. It was 6-6. And from then on, Buffalo just ran over Pittsburgh. And they haven't looked back. They won the next two games big by goal margins of 10. And they are winning this one by the same margin, 10 goals. Peter Martinello trying to figure out the secret.
The worst margin of victory in Turbo's history, a 19-10 loss to Philadelphia back on February 18th of 1989.
Pre-Gate. The pre-Gate era.
7 seconds to go as Gerrie Gait will try to spark the Turbos and does. What a fantastic shot.
Well, that one doesn't need words. Gerrie Gait, that's an all-pro shot. That's an all-world shot. He decided he was going to extend himself a little bit. He comes out, rack check, takes the ball away. It's all over right here. Now when he gets a step on his man, he's going to just go ahead and launch himself across the crease. Watch, one fake left and then just dives across. The ball is in the net before he lands in the crease. What a play. Nobody does it better than Gerrie Gait. He looks like he already said, he got the wake-up bell, I think, Craig, about 2 minutes ago.
And the quarter will end in the face-off circle. We've got 1 quarter to go. A miracle comeback by the Turbos? We'll find out. Game of the week on Prime Network. You can win a trip to the Major Indoor Lacrosse League World Championship game. Send your name, your address, and your phone number on a postcard to the address on your screen, or to enter by phone, 1-900-226-MILL, $2 per minute. You win tickets to the game, round trip airfare, hotel accommodations, and a lot more. And the Gates would like to get to the championship, and they're sparking their way to a comeback. Second Gates goal, first Gerrie, now Paul.
When these guys are on a mission, nobody's going to stop them, and all of a sudden, they have raised the level of their play about 20%. And when they're playing at peak level, this is what you're going to see a lot of. Nobody can play defense against them. Gerrie on a full run. Nobody's going to stop him there. Behind the back to Paul. Paul makes the big fake, freezes Gerrie, and then drops it in there. And don't forget, Gerrie has been in the whole game. And, Craig, that's going to take its toll. He's taken a lot of shots. He's played sensationally. But he's not going to be the goalie he was in the first quarter for the next 15 minutes.
Paul Gait with a shot. It bounces off the side of Brian Lemon and almost goes in the goal.
So it took Gates till halfway through the third quarter to score their first goal, but they've scored the last three for Detroit.
An interesting side note, the scoreboard operator has yet to put the goal on the scoreboard. I guess he thought that, well, now he finally does. He was worried a little bit that maybe the Turbos weren't going to score again and took an early night off.
There's your quarter scoring, 1-1. They won that first quarter, Buffalo did. We thought that was critical. It really gave them confidence to go ahead and blow out Detroit in the second and third quarter. And, of course, Detroit trying to make a late comeback. The Gates, 3 goals in a row.
Ryan Lemon called for a penalty.
Here's the hit that got him in the box. It's Keenan making the big move inside or an outside roll after he got Lemon all tied up. And that little slash move, not necessarily, that's kind of one that was a judgment call by the ref, puts him in the box. It'll be a 4-on-3 because there are two players in the box for Detroit, one for Buffalo. So a 4-on-3 power play.
Here's Keenan behind the back pass. Tavares inside Alexander. The goal had been moved off the line before the shot.
Alexander makes, if he takes that shot just 1 second sooner, it's a slam dunk. And he made just too many fakes and got nailed. Look at the third quarter stats. Again, nothing decisive there. Face-offs, Bandits in charge there. We knew that would be a key. Detroit's got to get better in the face-off department if they want to win in the fourth quarter. Meanwhile, Tavares parked on the same corner, Craig. He scored three times from that left-hand tight spot. They move it to the far side. Watch. Here's Kilgour on the far side. He looks out front. He looks away from the guy he's going to feed. Tavares parked on that pipe. That's three straight for him from that position. He scored three of the last four goals, and Tavares, fifth goal tonight. He may be the maiden hat trick. We'll have to look at the record books to find out, but he's one of the candidates. A couple guys have hat tricks. Alexander won. Tavares, of course, with five. But he's got a home down there, and what makes that effective, Craig, is when the ball movement is intense into the far side, he's open. The defense shot slides to the ball, and they hit him.
Gary Gait comes away with it. And now holding will give the ball back to Detroit. And take a look at these again.
Bandits winning the game and winning the keys. They got a maiden hat trick from any number of two guys. They've got the Gates to nine or less. They've got the first quarter won by tying it 1-1. They're doing well and command the game with a 16-7 lead. For the Turbos, less penalties. They haven't done that and consequently aren't winning. Faceoff efficiency, they haven't done that and consequently not winning. The Martinello line, plus minus, they're in the minus column. So I think the Turbos are down on all of their keys and find themselves down by nine goals.
Bandits on the attack. This is Hamley.
Keys of the game have become my life, Craig.
They have.
Trying to give the fans an insight to the game.
Keenan running the show. Brian Hall, ball loose in front. Alexander, you mentioned a slam dunk earlier. There's one over the top, two-handed.
His fourth goal of the night. He missed one from the pipe just moments ago. Medo Martinello confused. I tell you what, he needs the Gates to pull him up to another level. The ball comes in loose. Kevin so quick with a stick. I showed you how small a stick was at halftime, but he is so good as an athlete, he can pick it off the ground. There he is in the middle. He just happened to be there. Picks it off the ground and gets a moving Sammut. Kevin Alexander knew that he was in that scene, that nobody was watching him. He just turned around and shot it past Sammut. Boy, this will be tough to come back from. 17-7, chances are slim.
And the Bandits, I don't believe, are going to let up.
They're not going to forget the 23-17 win by Detroit. And they also lost in an exhibition.
Lee tries to send it long, but a beautiful interception by Darris Kilgour flips it to Gerrie, but Gerrie trying to clear it out. Couldn't quite get it all the way out. Pat Lee to Paul Gait. His shot saved by Gerrie.
Well, Gerrie owes him one. That was a terrible mistake. Kilgour made a sensational play, and then Gerrie just literally threw it away. Now that ball goes out of bounds, but Kilgour made the big play. Gerrie threw the ball away.
12:20 to go in the game. 17-7. This is Paul Gait.
He showed you his stick that he uses in very, very narrow.
Hiltz to Tavares. Hits the post. Gary Gait off the rebound. Counterattack. Brian Lemon. Back to Lancey. His shot hits the face cage. We'll go back the other way. Tavares. Veltman. Tavares plants himself. Couldn't quite get it around the angle.
Tavares has that corner all to himself. He missed two shots there. His last three scores have come from that spot.
Paul Day off the rebound of the shot by Meridian. Bob Hamley back to Mike Meridian. Centering pass shot by O'Hanlon goes wide. 17-7 the score. Back with more on Prime Network. As Tom Cruise might have said to the Turbos in the Color of Money, it just keeps getting worse, doesn't it?
Well, here comes Buffalo on a roll. Hiltz gets his hat trick for the night. Comes right down into the cylinder against Ron Martinello. That's that plus-minus we talked about, taking advantage of the lack of mobility from that line, who is a great scoring line. Now, Kilgour. Darris Kilgour gets his first goal of the night. Parks himself right in front. Gary Gait too late. He throws his stick in anger. 19-7. That's right, folks. 19-7, Buffalo. There are the scores. Hilt and Kilgour within a minute of each other.
Almost had another one there as Sammut saw one bounce off the post.
So Buffalo officially cracking the once invincible armor of this Detroit Turbo team.
Nikula with a shot. Veltman off the rebound. Here is Hall.
3-on-1.
Emick with a shot behind the back. Sammut with a save. No team has scored 20 on the Turbos this year. As a matter of fact, the total of Buffalo, the highest number of goals scored against the Turbos in 1992.
Well, I don't have the book in front of me, but I'm sure it didn't happen last year either. There's a goal by Paul Gate. His second in a row and the fourth Gate goal in a row, but not enough, I don't think. There's 7:26 left to get back into this one. And Gary's going to come out. We talked about him probably getting a little bit tired. And they're going to switch goalies, I think. Or is he coming out just for equipment? No, he's not coming out. He's got enough left, but a pad fell off. Here it is, the goal by Paul Gait. Looked very easy, nonchalant. 19-8 now, only 11 down, only. There's the sideline. Paul Gait, his third tonight. Don't forget, 8 goals he had personally the last time these two teams met. And there's his brother, Gary.
The EMF song, Unbelievable, playing in the background. It's quite appropriate for this game in toto.
I should say, this is something that the league will be shocked by when they hear this score.
Tavares tries to put it through as Sammut has the stick there. Long pass to Paul Gait. Paul Gait with a shot and a score. The Gates will not give up.
Is going to get the sideline for Buffalo a little bit scared, the fans of the match. Now, Gary, I wouldn't be surprised if he comes out tonight. I just think he's getting tired. Take nothing away from the great shot by Paul Gait. Gates are getting fired up here. They'll take it right down into the cylinder. Breaks into the middle, gets the full range of shot against that 4 by 4.5 foot goal, and just finds the corner. But when these two guys go to that extra level and are going 100%, there's very little you can do to stop them. They are tough to beat.
7:07 to go, 19-9.
Now they're saving the Gates, it looks like, just for offensive duty. You see, when they get the ball, they come off. Paul Gates, the first guy out, he gets the ball.
Paul Gates centering pass. Lancey with a shot. Gerrie with a save.
With 6:48 left, Craig, you're going to see Buffalo take the time now, take a little bit of the time off the clock. I don't see the goalie, Cowie, getting ready to play, so it looks like Gary's going to go the whole way, and he's had a sensational night. Alexander with the ball.
Here's Emick. And the league may want to start thinking about having a complete game stat for goalies.
Look at that shot by Alexander.
Oh,
now, you want to know, I mean, I don't have to tell you why this guy is in the Hall of Fame in the Box League in Canada. He hadn't played for 5 years. They brought him out to the Buffalo team, and he's still making this kind of impact at 35 years old. Takes it in, gets the pressure on his back, so he wraps it around behind the defender, gets smacked in the face. Sammut just watches it go in. Sensational shot by Kevin Alexander. And what is that for him? His fifth goal, Craig? Fourth goal. No, his fifth goal of the night.
So as we take a peek into the record book once again, this, the first time 20 goals have been scored since the Gates joined the team. Most ever scored against the Turbos, 21 back in 1990, a 21-19 loss to the Wings.
Pre-Gates, and I'm going to change that. It's Alexander's sixth goal. Take a look at it again. This is his sixth goal unofficially from my stats as you come in, wrap it around behind. He gets smacked from the front, and Sammut just watches it hit the twine right in the corner.
20-9.
The last two games, after the game against Detroit the first time, I'll get back to this point in a minute.
This is Bill O'Hanlon down the far boards. Having trouble controlling him is Terry Martinello.
They seem to find the secret, Craig. The first half of the game last time in Buffalo against Detroit, they lost. The second half of the game, it was a tie game virtually, and then they beat two teams by a margin of 10 goals. And they're winning this game tonight, obviously, by a margin of 10 goals or more, so they have really turned into the dominant force in the league.
New 30 seconds on the shot clock. Hamley will have it. 5:11 on the game clock. Hamley centering pass Meridian. Shot taken and a score, Jim Bissell.
And they are just having a field day. You'll notice nobody's knocking him out of the cylinder. The Gates are waiting on the sideline to get the ball, and they play great defense, but they're not on the field playing defense right now. Bissell takes that one in, and when they make two or three passes, you're going to get open guys. But normally in the cylinder, like right, watch as they drop down low. Now the ball came up from high. It was a higher shot than even I remember, but that shot from that high is savable, but nobody's in front of Sammut, and they just nail it right past him.
And that now officially the most goals ever scored against the Turbos, 21-9, and we still have almost 5 minutes to go. Gerrie Gait inside 11. What a save by Gerrie.
Gerrie is really playing a sensational game. Seen it all game long. You've seen saves like this. Look at this. Unstoppable, you would think. Here's Lemon right in front. He's got the whole net to shoot at. He can't get it past Gerrie.
Gerrie Gait with a shot as we return to action. Gerrie, 29 saves tonight. Intercepted pass on the counterattack.
3-on-2 now. It's down to even. Darris Kilgour pulled it back. He's got the clock working for him, so he just pulled it back to eat up some of that time. No way Detroit can come back now, and I'll have to tell you that, 21-9. Gates trying to pull this team back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the last five goals by the Gate Twins.
An errant pass, but at this point, it really doesn't matter.
We've got 4 minutes to talk about almost anything we want.
Here's Paul Gate to Gerrie Gait. They still have some show time to go. 3:50 to go, and can you believe it? 21-9.
And I'm going to score a bunch of goals tonight.
Tonight's game brought to you in part by the Radisson Hotel Pontchartrain, the official home of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League in Detroit. And the Buffalo Bandits will be sleeping well this evening if they're not celebrating after that one.
That's my fear. They won't be sleeping at all. Rocking the Hotel Pontchartrain till wee hours of the night.
Hopefully you have a room a couple of floors up.
Well, they've got a great reason to celebrate. What a season they've turned around. They could be the first expansion team ever to go ahead to the championship game.
Nikula with a shot. Save Gerrie.
When you look at MVPs, I got to give Gerrie my vote.
I'll second that.
He has been just absolutely unbeatable the whole night.
In case you're wondering, the largest margin of victory in MILL record book held by the Detroit Turbos. Margin of victory of 14 over Pittsburgh, 26-12. Last year.
Right here. This is very surprising. The Detroit team, we show you the trend. They sort of just are on a downside. They're losing confidence in their complete offense other than the Gates. And this one's really going to rock the management, the
turbo.
It's almost a little bit like the primaries are going. George Bush thinks he's got the nomination, and all of a sudden, there are a lot of got the message, didn't want it, gave it back. Apparently Buffalo is sending them a message right here. You haven't won the championship yet.
I was going to ask you for your George Bush impersonation, so why don't you go ahead and
not going to do it.
Why aren't you doing it?
Meanwhile, back in the game, Hamley with the shot. 2 minutes to go. This is Keenan.
Come on, Craig. Would it be prudent or not? When you look at offensive heroes in the game, Alexander certainly comes to mind. 6 goals. Hard to separate a hero here. I just think that Gerrie has kept the game getting away from the whole night. Alexander's had the shots. They've had a tough time on the defensive end of the floor, but I think it all starts on the defensive end of Buffalo's game, and I got to give my MVP to Gerrie.
Keenan in the corner. Detroit wanting one more goal, and they're having trouble just passing it around. Ron Martinello in front to Mueller. That one goes into the net, but the officials will not call it a goal. I wouldn't mind seeing that one again.
It's a tough one to call. It'll have a little impact on the game with 1:10 left. I talk about my vote for MVP. Of course, I'm not the official source. It's just my one little opinion.
Final minute of play. Hamley behind the back pass to Tavares. He'll flip it over to Darris Kilgour. And here comes
Brian Nikula.
Nikula is not going to give up. His shot goes down there, but look at the hustle on Brian Nikula.
Well, he likes to go to the left hand. He was in a bad spot there because he was being pushed to the outside. Left him a little bit not much to shoot at on that right side. Stick was on the good side. Here he is again.
That time he couldn't quite get a good shot. Got the rebound, however.
Brian's had a good game in ball movement. He's been pushing the offense when he has the ball and has had excellent shots.
Less than half a minute.
This will be a shocker. This is a shocker. This one will rock the league and give everybody a new hope for a real championship. And it's up for grabs now, it seems.
About to say one more for the Bandits? Maybe not, except Sammut is out of the crease, and Samut's just going to put that big stick on top of it. Keep it away from everybody. And Keenan will flip it in at the buzzer.
I think it counts. Keenan gets the goal at the buzzer. They give it to him. And meanwhile, Sammut was out trying to get a last lick in, a little bit of a payback. But Buffalo, as they had done all night long, they move the ball, 2 passes, open net for Keenan. And Keenan, a hero coming in. Watch this. Open goal. They move it all the way over to Keenan, just redirects it in. Boom, the buzzer goes off. The game's over. And that'll end it at 22-9.
That's what you call a very appropriate ending. 22-9. We'll be back to wrap it up on Prime Network. The surprising final from the Joe Louis Arena. The Bandits with a win. And let's take a look at the GMC truck play of the game. Talk about the strength of experience.
Well, Kevin Alexander did it tonight. He stepped forward. He gave the team the 2-1 lead early in the game in the second quarter. This was his 6th goal that gave them the 20-9 lead. But it was a sensational goal right in the throat of the action. And Kevin Alexander gets the GMC truck play of the game.
Our Coors Light player of the game, the goalie, Bill Gerrie, 31 saves tonight, standing by down on the field.
Now, Bill Gerrie, you don't look too happy, buddy. You had a sensational night. I thought it was one of the better nights of any goalie in the league. And I thought the key was the first quarter for you guys to really take away the intense offense that Detroit throws at you right off the opening faceoff.
Basically, that's what we talked about in the dressing room beforehand, was not letting them get out on us and getting a quick start like they have in the past games. And our defense has really come together in the last 3 games.
Well, your whole team has. You've won 2 games by a margin of 10, and then tonight against Detroit. I don't think even your team, with all the confidence you had, could have expected to win this handily. Your team has it all going.
No, we expected a close game. We expected like 16-12, 15-13, something like that. But I was surprised also by our offense. It was amazing.
Now we're watching a save that you made in the goal. Tremendous saves all night long. I thought also that you had tremendous support from that close defense. The matchups, Keenan, Veltman, maybe especially on the gates, really gave you a lot of help down in there.
Well, that was, again, that was before the game in the dressing room. We said we're going to match those guys up with the Gates. They've played against them before. They've played with them, so they know all the ins and outs, and they basically shut them down, I'd say, until the end, and I think we were all a little tired by the end.
Well, congratulations to you, Bill, our Coors Light Player of the Game.
Thanks a lot.
And he looks a little bit tired there. Go back and get yourself the refreshments that the victory game gives you. I tell you, tremendous night for him. Finally, a smile.
We're going to take a break and wrap it up from the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. 22-9, Bandits on Prime Network. Door Lacrosse League Game of the Week has been brought to you by Coors Light. It's the right beer now. By U.S. Air. U.S. Air begins with you. By Reebok. Life is short. Play hard. By STX Lacrosse Equipment. And by GMC Truck, the strength of experience. Quick look at the leading scorers for both teams.
Paul Gait, of course, with four goals. Too late, though. Started in the third quarter. Parke with two. Not enough scoring coming out of Detroit. A very unusual night for them. But look at the scoring here. Three guys with hat tricks. Alexander, Tavares, and Hills.
Bandits with two games to go against Boston and Baltimore. Detroit with one more game to go against Pittsburgh. Next week, we will see the Bandits against the Baltimore Thunder from Memorial Auditorium in Buffalo. Join us. Check your local listings on Prime Network. Final score, 22-9, Bandits for Leif Elsmo. This is Craig Johnson. So long, everybody, from Detroit. Tonight, from a sold-out odd in Buffalo, New York, it's the Baltimore Thunder against the Buffalo Bandits. And hello, everyone. Craig Johnson along with Bill Barroza. This building will be sold out, and I'm sure it'll be loud.
It's going to be loud, and it's going to be an advantage for the Buffalo Bandits as well.
It's a key game for both teams as we take a look at the divisional standings, first of all, in the National Division.
Well, Craig, I'll tell you, Buffalo has a chance to go into first place, and that's what they're interested in tonight, and they're going to play their hearts out to get there.
In the American Division, same holds true for the Baltimore Thunder.
Well, that's right. Both teams are 3-3, and Baltimore with a win tonight will be in tie for first place in the American League with the New York Saints.
The hottest team in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League, there's no doubt about it. They're named the Buffalo Bandits, and they're led by two key scorers.
Well, I'll tell you, Derek Keenan is third in the MILL behind the Gates brothers, Paul and Gary, in goals. But he couldn't be in that position unless he had a guy that was feeding the ball, and that's John Tavares.
For the Baltimore Thunder, experience really the key. Rick Sowell, that man.
Well, Rick Sowell, game in and game out. Again, he's seventh in the MILL, so we've got some fantastic scorers on both sides tonight. But a guy to compliment Ricky Sowell is Jeff Jackson. He faces off, he scores, he plays defense. And again, he's been a mainstay of this Baltimore team for a couple of years now.
It's an important game for both teams, as we said. What are the keys to the game?
Well, the keys are that Buffalo has to have the crowd, the 17,000 loud screaming people behind them, and they will, because when they score a goal, we won't be able to hear ourselves think. But more importantly is they have to keep the goals down, goals against, low.
For the Baltimore Thunder, I'm sure the crowd is also a factor. They're going to have to keep them quiet.
Well, they're going to have to hustle. They're going to have to count on their goaltending, and those are a couple of the key major points tonight.
Of course, shots on goal, a big key for the Baltimore Thunder, making sure that the ball gets somewhere near the net. It is a sellout crowd. The fans are filing in to the odd in Buffalo. And tonight's action is brought to you by Coors Light. It's the right beer now. By U.S. Air. U.S. Air begins with you. By Reebok. Life is short. Play hard. By Brian LaCrosse, the power behind the game. And by General Motors, GM is putting quality on the road.
U.S. Air, we do.
Everything we do, U.S. Air.
Before STX, lacrosse historically looked like this. Because of STX, lacrosse now looks like this. When it's your turn to make lacrosse history, do it with the original and best equipment in the game, STX.
They go to extremes to prove the engine durability of this Cadillac.
Let's cool it out. Hold on, Art. Let's dust them.
Punishing GM's V8 with the extremes of nature, with raging sand and freezing snow. One more reason why, after 5 years of driving, no luxury car made in America is more reliable than Cadillac.
Hey, Tom, how you doing back there?
Still going strong.
With 99 models redesigned and engineered, GM is putting quality on the road.
Over 17,000 Buffalo Bandits fans are ready for the Major Indoor Lacrosse League Game of the Week. The Bandits against the Thunder. Taking a look at the starting lineups. For Baltimore, Angotti, Britton, Johnson, Canby, Fred Hazen. Maybe a surprise in goal there?
That is a surprise, but we'll see how he does this evening. He's got the best goals against percentage, save percentage in the league.
There you take a good look at Tom Manos, 137 saves in five games. Bill Gary, whoa, 10 the nets for the Bandits. He got hot back in the game against Pittsburgh and was phenomenal last week against the Turbo.
Well, this will be a real test for Tommy Manos tonight, because after Buffalo proved they can score goals, 22 last week, he's in for a challenge tonight.
The face-off to get it started. Fred Haas for the Thunder. The Hall of Famer, Kevin Alexander for the Bandits.
And Kevin is one of the best face-off men in the world.
That face-off won by the Thunder, but a Thunder is hit. Of John Belt. Baltimore will control, although Vince Angotti having some trouble doing so.
It'll be interesting to see how Buffalo comes out tonight. They came out last week against the world champ Turbos, and they came out very physical, played a tough game on them. We'll see what they do tonight.
Here's Fred Haas, five on the shot clock for the Thunder. Shot from the outside, taken by Pat Rowe. Save Bill Gary two times. That'll go right into the stick of Holthouse.
You know what I noticed on that first shot and outlet is Buffalo is breaking right away, and Baltimore's got to be conscious and ready to play the fast break tonight.
Jeff Jackson at the point. This is the rookie, Tony Millon. His shot goes to the back of the net. Tony Millon with the goal, the rookie. Towson State.
Tony's had an up-and-down season, and I'll tell you, but he does have one of the hardest shots in the league. And it was interesting because it's an outside shot, but he just wanted to let this thing go and put it right between Geary's legs.
Now, Gerrie is used to the indoor game and may not be used to some of the field shots, so to speak, that a guy like Tony Millon may put on him.
Well, and see what happened there on that replay. It literally got screened by one of his Buffalo Bandits. So they're going to have to come out and play tougher defense on the shooters for Baltimore.
Interference, the call, and Buffalo loses possession to the Thunder. Kerwick will run the show. The Thunder running a whole bunch of people out there. Here's Kronberger. Knocked away by Mahar. Race for the ball. Fred Haas going after it right in front of his crease. Manos is there in the crease, and that one almost got by him.
That was a tricky play right there.
Curry tried to get it to Canby for the one touch. It didn't work.
We're watching a lot of hitting, a lot of physical activity down there.
And and I'm sure it won't be the last of it. Hiltz with a shot and a score!
You know, we said that the goaltenders are going to have to be hot in this game, and so far, two shots, one by each team, and basically, you know, simple goals. And the goaltender needs to build their confidence early in this game, because what can happen, they break the goalies early, and the goals just start flowing.
Gerrie Hiltz had his first hat trick against the Turbos last week. One goal towards that this week. We've played 2 minutes. Almost.
Well, he's another rookie, Gerrie Hiltz, for Buffalo. So one rookie answered the other one.
Alexander against Dan Britton on the faceoff.
Well, I called the last faceoff wrong. I told you how good Kevin is. We'll see what happens as the game goes on.
Faceoff won by the Bandits. Bill O'Hanlon, left-handed shot, deflected wide by Manos over the glass. And let's see who the possession will go to. And we'll go to Baltimore.
There's that physical toughness we're looking for. They're taking risks, taking some chances tonight.
Tony Millon. Mike Meradian. Shot clock already down to 10 as Rick Sowell takes it. Going against Bob Hamley. Rick Sowell trying to find positioning. Five on the shot clock. Kronberger with a shot. Pad save Gerrie. That one bounces over the top. Possession will go to the Thunder. Rick Sowell taking it in. Out front, Kronberger off the nice speed by Todd Curry. Makes it 2-1 Thunder.
Well, I don't want to make any predictions. I spoke to Brian Kronberger during warm-ups, Greg. He was out there on the floor. In the last game, he had 2 goals. He said, Bill, I'm going to try for 3 tonight. He was on a slump earlier on in the season. He's coming around in the second half here.
2-1 the score. Brian Kronberger with his 7th goal this year. 12:19 to go.
We're watching the shot again. The ball is moved nicely by Baltimore. 3 players actually touched it, and the guy that started that play was the leader, Ricky Sowell.
Alexander will handle the faceoff once again against Dan Britton.
They'll use Kevin in that faceoff opportunities as much as they can, as long as it won't tire him out.
Ball pops out, comes to the near board, and quite a hit there put on by Todd Canby. But the push will give the ball to the Thunder.
Well, here's the guy we were talking about, Derek Keenan, coming down with the ball now. 3rd and scoring in the MILL and goal.
Hall from the outside. That one goes wide to the left. Keenan off the rebound, looking for the shot, takes it right into the pads of Manos, who sprawls on top of it outside of the crease. We're going to take a break. Back with more 2-1 Thunder here at the Odd.
For every hoop junkie or casual fan, it is the NCAA tournament, and it is 3 weeks of exhilarating and exhausting basketball, heading down the road to Minneapolis in the Final Four. Let Nesson be your guide down this long and windy road. Tomorrow night, we'll look at who's hot and who's not in the field of 64, and who has the best chance of taking the crown from the Duke Blue Devils. So be here tomorrow night at 7:30 on Nesson. Your ticket to March Madness.
The NCAA High School and College Cheerleading Championships return to Nesson Friday night starting at 10. Don't miss a jump, vault, or tumble in this always exciting competition. That's Friday night starting at 10 on Nesson, your ticket to the best in sports action.
We welcome you back as the crowd going nuts. The Bandits with a goal at the 4:37 mark. 17,000 plus. Enjoying the way things are going so far.
That last goal to make it 5-3 was a fantastic play by Buffalo. They started a trick ball play all the way back on their defensive end of the field. Baltimore had no idea who had the ball coming down. He literally walked in on Manos, untouched by anybody, and scored a one-on-one goal.
5-3, Bandits making the hometown folks happy. Bob Hamley fighting with Matt Lewandowski on the faceoff. Hamley comes away with it. To Mike Moradian. Moradian going against Matt Kerwick. Moradian fights his way in there. And here comes Fred Haas. Haas all the way down, hit the post. Off the rebound, Kronberger tried to save it from going out of bounds. But the Bandits will have possession as the ball bounces into the Bandits bench.
The Baltimore's going to have to pick up the pace just a little bit here. And again, we said it earlier on that their on-goal shooting percentage has to remain high to be in this game.
Tony Millon with a fast break opportunity on the counterattack. Has Johnson there, but he's going to take it all by himself. Tony Millon, the rookie, fighting through two players, gets the shot off. Gerrie with a save, and we will see some penalties dished out here. Some Bandits on their way to the penalty box.
Well, Tony Millon did a really smart thing there. He comes down here. Actually, the smart thing was on the penalty, but he came down here. He should have looked to pass off to Ricky Sowell, who again was trailing him and was behind him and could have gone in unmolested. But when he did get knocked down and got a penalty on a Buffalo Bandit player, he didn't retaliate. And that's going to give him that man up, extra man position right now.
So as we take a look over in the penalty box, Bill Maher and Darris Kilgour both in the box, 2-minute penalties each. So a 5-on-3 situation for the Baltimore Thunder.
And you have to credit that two-man up to Tony Millon. Heads-up play, not fighting back when one of the Bandits went after him.
Jeff Jackson to Kerwick, centering pass, Sowell with a shot and a goal.
We talk about this guy every game. And he is a prolific scorer, and that was a bullet point-blank shot right in the top right-hand corner. We watched good ball movement here by Baltimore. They knew where they wanted to shoot from. The best place is up top, and again, he picked that top corner.
Now it will be a 5-on-4 situation. One more time, Rick Sowell.
And maybe he thought Ricky was going to bounce it, but again, it would have bounced up high anyway. So we'll see what he does late in the game, if he goes down or stays up tall.
And it's had possession off the faceoff. Tavares point blank. Millon comes away with it, taking it out of the crease. Millon nailed on the far side. Tackling his own man, making sure Tony Millon didn't go after anybody. The penalty box door is open once again, and this time Gerrie Hiltz will go in.
We watched the replay here, and the hit and the hold, it was actually the penalty, was for grabbing his jersey and pulling him. Again, it wasn't a hit, but it was a tremendous hit by Tavares.
Timeout called on the field by the Buffalo Bandits. 5-4 the score here at Memorial Auditorium. Jam-packed with over 17,000 people. The first time ever a major indoor lacrosse league game has been sold out before the day of the game. There's even people standing up in the rafters, standing room only, and it's not a cliche in this time and place.
Not at all, and I'll tell you, I've played many a game in the Philadelphia Spectrum. This crowd is as loud, if not louder.
Can you believe that scalpers were actually outside? I don't know if it's legal in New York, but there's some of the lucky people who got in.
Well, we're lucky we got in tonight. But these people are Bandit crazy, and they are behind their crowd, behind the team, excuse me. And they every goal that scored tonight, they scream so loud that you think it was the game-winning goal.
3:20 to go in the first quarter. Thunder on the power play after the 2-minute penalty to Gerrie Hiltz for holding. Here's Curry to Kerwick. Todd Curry, former Philadelphia wing player, sending it inside of Jackson. Quick shot off the rebound. Tim Welsh with the errant pass. And take a look at that statistic. Tells you a lot about the success of the Bandits.
Well, what's happened is, again, they were a young team, first year in the league. They weren't used to the game, the crowds, the whole aura of the MILL. And they have gotten used to it quickly, and they play like a veteran team now.
That defense, the key to last week's win over the defending champion, Turbo.
Well, what's interesting, again, is the last time Buffalo had a man short, Baltimore did not come out and try to double them, which is very surprising.
1 minute to go in the shorthanded situation.
I think Baltimore is happy if they don't give up a goal to Buffalo when they're a man down here.
30-second clock violation called against Buffalo. 54 seconds to go in the power play for the Baltimore Thunder as the veteran Rick Sowell will take it through the center circle.
And you know, that might not have been a bad play, and I'm sure it was strategic by Daryl Russell, the coach of Baltimore Thunder. He probably said, guys, let him kill the 30-second clock. We'll still have time on the man up, and we'll get it back and get a good shot.
Jackson trying the one-touch after the save by Gerrie. Long pass by Bill Gerrie. Too long. As John Tavares couldn't catch up to it.
Well, if that pass had connected, Buffalo had a breakout, and they had a two-on-one on Manos.
Whistle blows and timeout will be called by the Baltimore Thunder with 1:38 to go in the first quarter. And a 5-4 Buffalo Bandits lead.
I said Daryl Russell. I correct myself. Daryl is the general manager of the Baltimore Thunder, and as John Stewart was, you give credit to on that smart man down strategy.
Now here's a question for you as you see Buff McCready and the assistant coaches. Excuse me, that's, now you got me doing it. That's John Stewart talking to the Baltimore Thunder. How much does the general manager have a role in putting together a team as opposed to a coach?
You know, both. It's a joint effort. It's a joint effort on every team throughout the MILL because they know the players so well, both the general manager and the coach. I think the coach counts on the general manager to give them a lot of advice.
The Major Indoor Lacrosse League playoffs are coming up at the Spectrum on March the 29th at the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Tickets available now. Don't miss the action. Playoff action in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. 10 seconds on the power play as the Thunder looking for the shot. Kerwick out front, tried to go through the five hole, and quickly picked up there by Jim Veltman on a very good play.
Well, you were talking about the playoffs coming up, and that's the incentive for both of these teams to be in a good position to either get a bye, but certainly to make the playoffs.
Here's Jeff Jackson on the counterattack for the Baltimore Thunder in their red and gold. Kronberger with a shot right to the back of the net.
Well, Brian told me 3 goals tonight, so that's his second, and it's still the first quarter, so maybe he knows something we don't. Watch Baltimore pushing and pushing and pushing, and Buffalo did not do a good job of getting back on defense. Jeff Jackson moves it across. Not a good pass. Brian did an excellent job. And again, where Gerrie had made that save with his left arm before, he misses that one. He should have moved his entire body across the goal.
Brian Kronberger, his second goal tonight, 8th of the season. Off the faceoff, controlled by Fred Haas, but he loses his stick there for a moment. Puts it between his legs, back to Jim Huelskamp.
Huelskamp is a veteran on his team, and he's out there as a defensive specialist, but he'll contribute every so often with a goal.
One of the 6-year men in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. A 1-year man, Tony Millon, taking a shot there. Kerwick picks it up. Behind the goal, taken away by Bill Gerrie. Dan Britton tried to take it away from him. Bandits with an opportunity, but it's stolen away by Tony Millon.
Well, I'll tell you, Gerrie is getting into this game emotionally, physically, and behind the goal, he was taking a couple of chops at the Baltimore player there, and the referee didn't even see it. We may see it on the replay here. He comes out to try to play defense, but then when the ball ends up being loose after this hit, his stick is swinging.
Lewandowski with a shot, Bill Gerrie with a save. Dan Britton with a rebound. Here's Tony Millon. Millon fires it and scores with 5.2 seconds to go in the quarter.
I saw Tony Millon earlier in the season, Craig, go through five players when they played the Boston Blazers up in Boston. And it surprised me then, I mean, how incredible of an athlete he is. And he goes through quite a few here. Again, controls his stick and puts in a nice goal.
Tony Millon out of Towson State with his second goal tonight, number 7 on the year. 12 points in 1992 for the rookie. There is Kilgour off the faceoff, and time will run out in the first quarter of play. Here at the Odd in Buffalo, the visitors are leading by 1-5, but you know the fans are going to get into it and try to bring their Bandits back on Prime Network.
Out here, nothing is left to chance.
Check on the 1130 eastbound.
Right on 10.
That's why Burlington Northern buys reliable, durable trucks, like their 1500 Chevy trucks. Chevy full-size pickups are unsurpassed on overall quality.
We're in the clear. See you on your way back through.
With 99 models redesigned and engineered, GM is putting quality on the road.
I'm Rick Sowell, the Baltimore Thunder, and I'm going to score a bunch of goals tonight.
We'll see about that. And you can see it on the Mill Home video.
This exciting video is full of the greatest action from the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. To order, send a cashier's check or money order for $9.95. That's right, only $9.95 plus $3 postage and handling to Mill Home Video, 9200 Ward Parkway, Suite 500, Kansas City, Missouri, 64114. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery.
Six to five as we're ready to start quarter number two in front of 17,000 plus at the Odd. You can fly away to the World Championship game. Send your name, address, and phone number to the address you see there, or call 1-900-226-MILL, $2 per minute to enter. You get tickets to the game, round trip transportation via U.S. Air, hotel accommodations, and a lot more. Buff McCready would like to see his team go to the championship game. Start of the second quarter. Kilgour against Haas on the faceoff. It's picked up by Tom Johnson. His shot won't go, but Tom Johnson himself went into the goal. And now Gerrie Hiltz going at it with Johnson. Apparently thought he got a little bit too close to his goalie. And the officials have both men pinned.
I don't even know who's in there. I can't see who's under the pile.
I think that's Tom Johnson on one side in the red and Gerrie Hiltz in the black and orange, although it is very difficult to tell under there.
Well, that's who it is. It's certainly a mismatch at 6'2", 190 for Tom Johnson. And Hiltz, 5'7", 160. And Johnson is a tough guy.
Johnson pleading innocence. Gerrie Hiltz has already taken his seat. One more look at it, and let's see how it all got started.
I think he comes down, tries a one-on-one, and again, everything was absolutely clean, no problems, and I think Johnson started that little fisticuffs there.
The result of it will probably be a 4-on-4. And you got to give credit to the Major Indoor Lacrosse League officials. They don't mind getting in the middle of it to stop it.
Well, if you had one of those helmets on, you'd be okay too, I think.
I don't think I'd get in the middle of it.
I don't think I'd wear those helmets. I don't know.
And I'm 6'4", 225, and I wouldn't get in the middle of it. We're going to take a break while they sort this out on Prime Network.
Today, Deitrich Shoe Corporation announced a major retail expansion in 25 U.S. cities.
When I see a company that looks like a good investment, I check it out myself. At Charles Schwab, I can get quotes, financial news, and when I make a trade, commission savings.
For free information about Schwab services, call toll-free 800-338-8000.
March is a big month in the world of sports, and Nesson Sports Desk, the morning edition, will bring you all the excitement. Tune in every weekday morning, anytime between 5 and 9, and in 15 minutes, Sports Desk will give you in-depth coverage of the Bruins and Celtics as they drive toward the playoffs, the March Madness of the NCAA tournament, and of course the Red Sox as they prepare for the 92 season in spring training. So don't miss a minute of the action. Catch it all on Nesson Sports Desk, the morning edition.
Hold on, folks. Buckle up.
Barkley for three. Oh, no!
Inside he comes.
If you love basketball, this is the show for you.
Yes!
Oh, my!
The plays of the week, player profile, and magic moments from the past. It's all in NBA action.
NBA action, Tuesday nights at 7 on NESN.
Bork for the defense. Don't miss this one-time offer of a limited edition commemorative print. Bork for the defense is a collector's item with only 2,000 available, each numbered and signed by Bruins All-Star Ray Bork. A great gift idea for any season. Bork for the defense is printed on 100% linen from the studio of New England sports artist Neil Portnoy. Send $34.95 plus tax and handling today and get Bork for the defense.
We return you to the odd in Buffalo, 11-8. Bandits, let's get you caught up. Tony Millon scoring the goal to tie the game at 7. Then it was the Bandits' turn. Kevin Alexander will make it 8-7 with his second goal of the night, a power play goal. Derek Keenan would make it 9-7 off of nice feed by Bob Hamley. Curry tried to bring the Thunder back with a goal hit. And there you take a look at the scoring summary, bringing you up to date. But add to those scores those Veltman and Keenan to make it 11-8. And we return you to action here at the odd with a behind the back shot and a goal.
The crowd is loving it tonight. Mark Burnham had trouble breaking into the lineup, into the starting lineup for Buffalo, and he has contributed in the last several games for him and played very, very well and an unbelievable behind-the-back shot. We see it again here on replay. Again, not a whole lot of opening in the goal to get a goal by Tommy Manos. But I'll tell you, this is a shooter's game tonight. It's not a goaltender's night.
Here comes Gerrie. Hiltz. Tavares takes a shot, deflected wide by Manos. And right now, the Thunder having to play comeback lacrosse. And Gotti brings it down. Fred Haas fakes, but can't get it around Bill Gerrie.
Well, we saw Baltimore come back from 6 or 7 goals down earlier this season against the Blazers. So they are absolutely not out of this game, and they know they can come back.
17,000 people hope you're wrong. Bissell has it stolen away. Tim Wells bringing it down. He loses his footing and then loses the ball. Bissell comes away with a long pass. Hops by Kilgour, but away from the ball, a penalty has been called.
Stay in your seats and watch all the excitement.
Got a Buffalo player headed to the box. Number 21, Jim Bissell.
So this will give the opportunity for the Thunder on the power play, which has not been that accurate. Only one power play goal for the Thunder so far.
No, and Baltimore had the advantage in shots. shots during the game, but they're not taking advantage of them, putting them on goal where they need to be.
Rick Saul. Around they go. This is Jeff Jackson. Curran. In front. One touch. Jackson. Shot in the goal.
And the Baltimore is showing Buffalo they've got as good a stick work as the Bandits do. When you watch the Bandits move the ball, they are incredible. But Baltimore did just as a fantastic job there. We watch the replay here. Again, everybody on the team is touching the ball. They move it, and Jackson on a quick release. Again, not a whole lot of angle to shoot at. They move it nicely, and we'll watch it here from a shooter's vantage point. He's got very little to shoot at.
Jeff Jackson, the leading scorer for the Thunder, 19 goals this season. That's only his first of the night, however. Veltman flips it into the corner for Tom Emick. Emick takes it up top for the Hall of Famer Kevin Alexander, who tried to get it to Veltman, but it bounced through. Manos will reel it in.
Well, we've got plenty of time on the game clock for the first half here, and we've got a goal fest going on. We could break records tonight.
Here's John Holthaus to Tim Welsh, looking for the centering pass. But the Bandits are keeping the center clock. Tim Welsh with five on the shot clock. Takes the shot, it goes wide, but that will cause a 30-second violation.
He took a shot, but again, missing the goal does not reset the shot clock. It's got to be on goal.
Derek Keenan, a big part of the Bandits' offense. Tim Welsh tried to loop it in for Emick, and does! He got his stick out there, just barely got the ball forward, and Tom Emick puts it past Manos, 13-9.
Well, we watch the replay, and Derek Keenan driving, dumps it off to get rid of it, and the goalie should have come out and clamped on that ball, and certainly gained control. He tried to pick it up out of the air, which was the mistake. And again, Baltimore not playing good, close, in tight defense. They've got to become more physical in there.
You think the Bandits are psyched about this one?
Well, they see a chance for first place again. It won't assure them first place, but a chance toward first place by the end of the season.
There's Kilgour, has it knocked away by Fred Haas on the stick check. Thunder will take possession. A win by the Thunder would put them in a tie for first atop the American Division with the New York Saints.
Well, both these teams, again, are looking for playoff hopes, and they're both probably in the playoff hunt, but they're looking for that top seed.
Gerrie strips the ball away from Rick Saul. And Bill O'Hanlon. Give it off to Paul Gary. Here's Bob Hamley. 4:44 to go, first half. Out front, shot, score. Bill O'Hanlon.
And the mistake that Baltimore is making is they're sitting back in their defense. They're not coming out and challenging the Buffalo players. You watch the ball up top. He's looking uncontested at another player inside where he shouldn't have been standing there without a bit being hit with the stick physically, certainly after the shot at least. But the problem that you see is the fact that the guy got to feed the ball inside. He should have never been able to feed the ball so cleanly.
Tavares, give and go. He tries to put the shot.
That was a fantastic save by Tommy Manos there.
We're going to take a break. 14-9 Bandits here at the Odd. Back with more of the Game of the Week on Prime Network.
The plan. No. The cinnamon. No. The chocolate.
Dunkin' Donuts introduces new minis. They're smaller than our regular donuts, so now you don't have to choose just one. You can have more of your favorites each time you come in.
No, the frosted, the coffee rolls, no, the butternut, the glaze.
Buy plenty of new Dunkin' Minis, so you won't get caught short.
Super Sports Month continues Thursday with a live day-night doubleheader featuring the Boys of Summer and the Big Bad Bruins. At 1, the Red Sox travel to Fort Lauderdale, Florida to take on the Yankees as new managers Butch Hobson and Bucky Showalter begin to get acquainted. Then at 7:30, Adam Oates greets his old mates as the St. Louis Blues return to the Garden. So be sure to tune in Thursday for Red Sox baseball at 1 and Bruins hockey at 7:30 on Nesson, your ticket to the best in Boston sports action.
We welcome you back to Buffalo, New York. This town belongs to the Bandits, and so far, so does this game. Rick Sowell with a shot, trying to get the Thunder back into it. Long bounce off the rebound, controlled by Keenan. It's a shorthanded situation for the Bandits as Tavares in the penalty box. Veltman with a pass, shot, score! Darris Kilgour!
Kilgour comes in, and again, they are short-handed here. Buffalo's got a man in the box. Baltimore's got to take advantage of that. Beautiful one-on-one, and Baltimore is allowing Buffalo to break inside.
There is Kilgour with his 19th goal this season. He, for the first part of the season, was the offensive leader, but now the scoring has been spread around. Rick Sowell has it stolen away. Here come the Bandits again. Darris Kilgour tries the shot. Brian Hall off the rebound. Centers it. Jim Veltman. Backhanded pass. Almost got back to Kilgour.
Buffalo's offense looks stronger when they have one less player on the field than they do when they're all even, 5-on-5.
Tremendous hustle by Veltman. Darris Kilgour. One-on-one, Brian Hall, score!
You can't stop this Buffalo team one-on-one. Their shooters are too good. That's why they lead the MILL in shooting percentage, shots on goal. They are now a man short again. Buffalo breaks one-on-one. Tom Manos doesn't have a whole lot to help him there.
Number 16 with 2:37 to go in the first half.
But Baltimore,
this is a score fest.
Oh, absolutely. And Baltimore's been in a position where they've been down before, but I don't think they've ever been down to a team with the caliber of the shooters that Buffalo has.
Brian Hall with the 7th goal this season, and we could be on our way to seeing a record. 16 goals and one half alone. We're going to take a break. 2:37 to go in the first half from the odd in Buffalo. 17,000 plus are enjoying it. This just one of the reasons why.
I'm Rick Sowell of the Baltimore Thunder, and I'm going to score a bunch of goals tonight.
We'll see about that, and you can see it on the Mill Home Video.
This exciting video is full of the greatest action from the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. To order, send a cashier's check or money order for $9.95. That's right, only $9.95 plus $3 postage and handling to Mill Home Video, 9200 Ward Parkway, Suite 500, Kansas City, Missouri, 64114. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery.
Hard you work, we'll work that hard for you. We believe in putting people first in everything we do.
Every time we fly, every mile of sky,
everything we do.
We are back at the Odd in Buffalo. And And the Thunder working with a change, but right now trying to make the most of a power play, which has 15 seconds left on it. On the shot clock.
Yeah, their power play has not been effective tonight.
Jeff Jackson trying to make it effective. Couldn't get it by Gerrie. 30-second violation, and the ball will be turned over. And when Buffalo comes down, they will see a new goalie in the goal. Steven Deitrich, 77% save percentage. A lot of his friends and family are here tonight to watch the game.
Well, I'll tell you, he came in cold, and it's tough for a goaltender coming in without being warmed up. Came in off the bench and made a fantastic split save, first one. We'll see how he stands up over time.
This is Rick Sowell, the team leader. Tim Welsh trying to send a low pass to Holthouse. Tavares. Restraining line. Bob Hamley trying to get it over for Meridian. Less than a minute to go in the first half. 16-9 Bandits. Ball loose, picked up by Paul Day. Bandits want to put one more on the scoreboard. And they do!
Paul Day just does it all alone. It didn't look like it was a difficult shot. We'll watch the replay again. Not a lot of power on it, but he placed that. And again, a cold goaltender coming in. It's tough to be ready to play in the game. Emotionally, you're into it. Physically, you're not there. You don't have all your movements down.
11 different players have scored the 17 Bandit goal. 17-9. Less than 30.
Buffalo's proven to me tonight is their game against Detroit last week when they scored 22 goals was not a fluke. They are a good team.
Deitrich has the save, but the delayed penalty will put one of the Baltimore Thunder players into the penalty box. And the fans love Bill Gary as they are literally chanting his name at the odd.
Well, not only is there an right now, Buffalo, with the powerful power play that they have with this stick work, their odds of scoring right now are pretty darn good.
Power play opportunity, clock winding down, and the Thunder will see this clock run out on them quite possibly as Angotti has it in midfield, but no way to shoot the ball. The fans here in Buffalo will enjoy what they're seeing as they get up on their feet.
We've got a standing ovation, and that's 17,000 plus. I think they want us to stand too.
Coors Light halftime report coming up. We're going to talk about the playoffs. Bandits look like they're on their way in a big way.
General Nutrition Performance Amino 1000, the scientifically developed protein supplement. Amino 1000 can help give you the edge. The Amino 1000 gel capsule, designed for fast absorption. Amino 1000, exclusively at GNC, the authority in sports nutrition.
Lacrosse is America's fastest growing and most exciting sport. For all your lacrosse needs, it's Allman Sports International. Allman has the best in protective equipment. Custom sticks with exclusive Allman pockets. The latest t-shirts, team jerseys, shorts, jackets, and a full line of officials gear. Ullman Sports International has everything you need to play your best and look great doing it. For a free catalog, call 1-800-BESTIC.
It's a big dance, March Madness, an annual rite of passage for every hoop junkie or casual fan. It is the NCAA tournament, and it is 3 weeks of exhilarating and exhausting basketball, heading down the road to Minneapolis in the Final Four. Let Nesson be your guide down this long and windy road. Tomorrow night, we'll look at who's hot and who's not in the field of 64, and who has the best chance of taking the crown from the Duke Blue Devils. So be here tomorrow night at 7:30 on Nesson. Your ticket to March Madness.
Super Sports Month continues Thursday with a live day-night doubleheader featuring the Boys of Summer and the Big Bad Bruins. At 1, the Red Sox travel to Fort Lauderdale, Florida to take on the Yankees as new managers Butch Hobson and Bucky Showalter begin to get acquainted. Then at 7:30, Adam Oates greets his old mates as the St. Louis Blues return to the Garden. So be sure to tune in Thursday for Red Sox baseball at 1 and Bruins hockey at 7:30 on Nesson, your ticket to the best in Boston sports action.
Networks Major Indoor Lacrosse League Game of the Week continues from Buffalo. Coors Light halftime report 17-9. The Bandits with a halftime lead. Craig Johnson, Bill Barroso along with you as we move closer and closer to playoff time. A very exciting time for all the teams in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League.
Well, every team in the MILL has a chance for the playoffs right now. It's that close. Again, Baltimore and Buffalo at 3-3. They're both vying for those American League and National League first place spots.
Let's take a look at the playoff format. It will be the same for both the National and the American Division. The second and third place teams will play against each other. The winner to take on the first place team in the division. And two playoff games have been confirmed due to the higher attendance number. Those games in Philadelphia at the Spectrum on March the 29th and at the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit on April the 4th. Tickets are available now. Bill, I'm sure you're getting your tickets already.
Absolutely. I'll tell you, you look at tonight's game and you think about Buffalo and how well they're playing. They are a contender for this championship this year.
You people in Philadelphia and Detroit, get your tickets now for exciting Major Indoor Lacrosse League action, playoff style. We'll be back with more on the Coors Light Halftime Report, taking a look at highlights and the statistics when we return to Buffalo, New York.
That's ridiculous.
Because you believe these trucks shouldn't carry a spare tire.
It's a ride beer now.
Because up here, crisp-tasting beer just comes naturally.
It's a ride beer now.
Because when the whole gang gets together, there's no room for filling up. So reach for the silver bullet, the beer that won't weigh you down.
It's a ride beer now.
They wanna live, play how they wanna play, dance how they wanna dance, kick and they snap a friend.
Too Legit to Quit, the new album from Hammer.
Racing fans know nothing can match the speed, power, and action of NASCAR. The best drivers in the world pushing 200 miles an hour in heart-stopping racing excitement. And nothing brings you closer to the action than the NASCAR Video Collection. Each one-hour cassette takes you behind the scenes with exclusive footage you won't see anywhere else. Get an insider's view of the developments in America's fastest-growing sport. You can start your NASCAR Video Collection at this special introductory price of only $9.95. Other cassettes will follow about every month for the regular price. There's no obligation. Cancel anytime. Join the NASCAR video team now. It's the inside track to America's ultimate motorsport, NASCAR.
To audio for a 60-minute NASCAR video, call now, toll-free, 1-800-762-7900. Use your credit card. Get the special introductory price of only $9.95. Call now, 1-800-762-7900. That's 1-800-762-7900.
back on the Coors Light halftime report. 17-9. The Bandits lead it. The Bandits have scored 6 out of the last 7 goals, and it all started like this.
Well, Mark Burnham, again, a guy that hasn't played a lot for them this year, makes a nice behind-the-back shot. Not a lot of open goal. Manos.
Brian Hall getting the shot here.
I'll tell you, Buffalo is very, very accurate in their shooting, the best in the league, and you see him pick another corner there on Manos.
Taking a look at the first half statistics. Shots on goal, 32-30. The Thunder leading in overall shots, but they just can't get them past Bill Gehring.
Well, that's exactly it. He's gotten hot for them. He's played well. Again, and Buffalo's strength has come on the fact that they are the league-leading percentage scoring team.
Hall and Tavares with a hat trick each. Keenan with 5 assists for the Thunder. Tony Millon with a hat trick. 1 goal each for Jeff Jackson, Rick Saul, and Todd Curry. That's the Coors Light halftime report. Back with a second half faceoff when we return. 17-9, Bandits.
I'm Rick Sowell of the Baltimore Thunder, and I'm going to score a bunch of goals tonight.
We'll see about that, and you can see it on the Mill Home video.
This exciting video is full of the greatest action from the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. To order, send a cashier's check or money order for $9.95. That's right, only $9.95 plus $3 postage and handling to Mill Home Video, 9200 Ward Parkway, Suite 500, Kansas City, Missouri, 64114. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery.
Business is trucks, and has been for over 80 years. A dedication to truck strengths and values to keep in mind. Because when you need to haul something, tow something, carry precious cargo, find new trails, or simply ride high and proud, there's nothing quite as strong as a truck. GMC Truck, the strength of experience.
Ladies of Lacrosse.
It's not a game. It's an adventure.
Coors Light and Major Indoor Lacrosse present the Boston Blazers versus the Buffalo Bandits. Saturday night, March 21st at the Boston Garden. Listen up. Great tickets are only $10 in advance, so don't miss out. You saw the Blazers beat New York. Now watch them bury Buffalo. You gotta see it to believe it. Remember, great seats only $10 in advance. See the Boston Blazers take on the Buffalo Bandits. Saturday night, March 21st at the Boston Garden. We'll sell you the whole seat, but you'll only need the edge.
Hold on, folks. Buckle up.
Irvin, catch it, Johnson.
Barkley for 3. Oh, no!
Inside he comes.
If you love basketball, this is the show for you.
Yes!
Oh, my! The plays of the week, player profile, and magic moments from the past. It's all in NBA action.
NBA action, Tuesday nights at 7 on NESN.
17-9, the halftime score. One of these two teams would love to go to the championship. You have an opportunity to by entering the US Air MILL Fly Away contest. There's the address on your screen saying your name, your address, your telephone number, or call the special 900 number set up for the Fly Away promotion. $2 per minute. 17-9, and we could see some records broken here in half number two.
Well, the most goals by one team was the Detroit Turbos against Pittsburgh in January of last year, 1991 season. And again, the Bandits are on a way to do that.
Derek Keenan picks up the opening faceoff. And the Bandits now the highest scoring team in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. They're working with a power play. Deitrich able to deflect the ball to the side. 1:17 to go in the power play, but for Buffalo. But Baltimore with possession here. Kerwick unable to catch up to the ball. And Darris Kilgour will start it off for the Bandits.
It's not that tough being down in the MILL. The tough part is being down by 8 goals playing Buffalo in Buffalo at home with 17,000 screaming fans.
Darris Kilgour out front to Hamley. Shot is high off the rebound. Tavares tried to put it in. Nice rebound by Keenan to Alexander. Low shot deflected to the side by Britton. He gets his own rebound, puts the shot, and saved by Steven Deitrich.
Well, Dietrich's had a chance to get warmed up, and he's playing very well now.
Kerwick with a shot and a goal on the fast break. 17-10.
Second-year player from Hobart College, Matt, has been a scorer for the Baltimore Thunder. And again, this is a team, an experienced team, that came from the championship game last year and is as good as any team in the league. And you're going to see Matt come down here on a fast break, one-on-one, and they can shoot very well. He picks out a corner on Gerrie there. So I'll tell you, if I'm Buffalo, I don't want to rest on my laurels and sit back and say, where you got a cushion now, because they don't.
Matt Kerwick with his 15th goal this season, first of the night, 17-10. Thunder with the first score in the second half. Over and back, the call on the power play situation.
One thing Baltimore is going to have to do and concentrate on is not throwing the ball away. They've got to take advantage of it when they have the ball.
Kerwick tried the centering pass to Millon. Dan Britton going after it.
That's an example right there, Craig, where they didn't have a smart play. They threw the ball away. They've got to get a better shot. They've got to take a shot every possession.
Jim Veltman with control of the ball. The shot blocked on the outside. Tim Welsh trying to start the break. Over to Rick Sowell. Centering pass to Pat Welsh. It hit the post, and the officials may say it's a goal. They look back at the goal judge. Goal judge very noncommittal about it. And it's a goal. Let's take another look at it. We will let you be the judge.
I don't always guess he's right, but it looked like it went in, and I'm talking too soon maybe, but we'll see in 1 second here. We got some good camera guys here. That was absolutely in the goal. That was a goal, no question about it, and the referee made an excellent call on that play.
Not a popular decision here in Buffalo, but a good decision on the parts of the officials.
Well, and the fans are you know, a little, you can hear them in the crowd in the background. They don't know that it was officially a goal, so they're going to have to watch it, and they'll see the replay maybe in one of their special booths here.
17-11, the score. The Thunder with the first 2 goals of half number two, trying to come back reminiscent of their game against the Blazers, which you saw here on Prime Network. Here's Rick Sowell.
You've got to be impressed with the tenacity of Baltimore. I mean, they are running. They're not a team to ever quit.
Kerwick with a shot. Gerrie with a save. Dan Britton tried to get the rebound, but had the ball taken away from him. Bandits on the counter. This is Bob Hamley. Around the pick by Meradian. Give and go. Meradian with a shot. Deitrich in front of the goal two times. Hamley on the follow-up. This is John Holthouse.
And you can see the difference between a Steven Deitrich that's warmed up and one that's not. He came in the second half and has been playing excellent.
We've played 3 minutes of the third quarter. 17-11, Rick Sowell positioning. Shot Kronberger, it's loose. That'll be a crease violation. As Matt Lewandowski stepped into the crease, if there was some way he could have taken his stick and pushed it in there, that would have been a goal, but he did step in the crease.
We'll watch the replay again here. Loose ball. Gerrie makes a nice save, but loses where it is.
Well, as we return, John Tavares scores a goal, making it 18-11, and the fans here are saying maybe the Bandits didn't go to sleep at halftime.
That happens quite. quite often. Again, you've got such a comfortable lead, you come out and you're a little lackadaisical about coming out playing hard because you've got the advantage. Baltimore, like a trapped, you know, rat, was backed in the corner. They had to do something.
Baltimore. Trying to get up to Millon. Tavares with the interception. It brings it down to Darris Kilgour. Kilgour fighting his way in there. Millon with a check from behind. Tavares with the ball. Hills picks it up, tries to put it through the legs of Stephen Deitrich, and a penalty will be called. We'll catch you up when we return. 18-11 Bandits on Prime Network.
Look closely. This amazing dental breakthrough can clean your teeth better than you've ever cleaned them before. Introducing Power Plaque 2000. It reaches deep down where plaque builds up and scours it away with bristles counter-rotating thousands of times per minute. Why risk all this? Power Plaque 2000 is recommended for everyone. It comes with an extra brush and convenient stand, all for the incredible low price of only $19.95. But wait, order now and get the complete Dazzle Tooth Whitener absolutely free. Just use this proven three-step process for a dazzling smile. Free. It's the perfect combination for the giveaway price of only $19.95. Call now.
Call 1-800-733-8300 or send check or money order for $19.95 plus $4 shipping and handling to Power Plaque 2000, 4500 American Way, Roanoke, Virginia.
20-12, the Bandits with the lead as John Tavares scores two goals, one on a power play goal, then Darris Kilgour makes it 20-11.
That was an outside shot, which was very surprising for as well as Deitrich was playing for him to give up that last goal.
Tim Welsh with a diving shot to make it 20-12.
And Tim Welsh came up the floor after that for the next faceoff with determination. He said, we're 8 goals down, guys, but let's not give up. They're not.
A series of penalties makes it a 4-on-3 situation in favor of the Thunder as we return. Kerwick up top to Todd Curry. Curry looking for the shot. He takes it wide to the right side. Off the rebound. Kronberger has trouble controlling it. To Rick Sowell to Kerwick. His shot. Goes in the goal.
That was an excellent call on the official's part. Gerrie was inside the goal, and when we watch the replay, you'll see his stick over the goal line.
That will release one player out of the penalty box. As let's take another look at it here.
Well, Kronberger comes down the middle, a nice behind the back. Ricky Sowell does the right thing, moves it cross goal, and you see where the goalie stick is. It was inside behind the line, and then he kicks it out. Another excellent call by the official tonight.
I'm not quite sure. My memory's failing me a little bit, but what wasn't it Kerwick that had shot the goal that the officials went down to look at and make sure that it was a goal? Do they have something against Matt Kerwick? Or actually something for them if you listen to the fans who are sitting behind us. 20-13, 8 minutes to go in the third quarter. Rick Sowell looking for the centering pass. Rick Sowell with a shot save. Gerrie. Sowell fighting for the rebound. Kronberger can't get it. But Pat Welsh catches up to it. And penalties are called both ways. Pat Welsh will go to the box for the Thunder. And Brian Hall will go to the box for the Bandits.
Well, we could set a lot of records tonight. We could set a record for most goals scored by a team. Could be most goals scored by both teams and penalties. We've seen a heck of a lot of penalties tonight.
And a couple game ejections. Timeout is called by the Buffalo Bandits. 20-13, a 7-goal lead for the home team. 7:42 to go in quarter number 3 here in the Odd in Buffalo. Sold out, packed to the rafters.
Buffalo.
Well, we can't forget about the playoffs coming up, and again, Baltimore's thinking about that. They've got
this exciting thing is available to you now with the Mountain Chains out of the Concourse.
We will be in the Boston Garden as the Bandits take on the Blazers. Check your local listings here on Prime Network. A big game for the Bandits, especially with some of the other games going on. That one could be for the Bandits, one that could give them the division title.
And Boston's no team to take lightly. They've got a lot of speed, great goaltending, excellent team, and they were in the playoffs championship game 2 years ago.
Well, as you take a look at Steven Deitrich, he looks downfield at a rarity, a three-on-three situation. Here's Kronberger, joined by Curry and Sowell, against Darris, Kilgour, Keenan, and Veltman.
What about the goals?
Very empty-looking field out there.
You know, if I were Coach John Stewart, I might have thought about pulling my goaltender and had a four-on-three and trying to, you know, make that comeback alive right now.
One shot is all the Thunder will get. Here's Veltman trying to get around Rick Sowell. Veltman gets the shot away. Deitrich pulls it in. And Rick Sowell must be a little bit frustrated.
Baltimore had a chance for a break there. And when Ricky didn't control that ball very well there in the corner, that slowed down Baltimore's break. They could have beat Buffalo back into the hole.
Same players out there for the Bandits. Three new players for the Thunder. It's 4-on-4 as two players come out of the box now. Gerrie with the save. The outlet pass to Bill Kirk. Hamley will run the show. Hamley takes the shot. Stick save, Deitrich.
He got a possible breakaway if Baltimore picks it up, and he ran by the ball.
Tim Welsh picks it up. In front for Holthouse. Holthouse could not control it. Bissell, the long pass. Kerr out front to Bissell. Delayed penalty coming up as Deitrich steals the pass away. A penalty will be called with 5:52 to go, third quarter. 20-13 the score. Buffalo leading.
The Corvette uses premium fuel for hot performance. The human body needs premium nutritional fuel for top performance. Whatever your sport, General Nutrition has hot sports nutrition products for you. With heavyweight gainer 900, just one serving delivers over 900 low-fat calories to help you pack on the pounds. Champions heavyweight gainer 900. Accelerate to top performance. GNC, the authority in sports nutrition products.
Lacrosse is America's fastest growing and most exciting sport. For all your lacrosse needs, it's Allman Sports International. Allman has the best in protective equipment. Custom sticks with exclusive Allman pockets. The latest t-shirts, team jerseys, shorts, jackets, and a full line of officials gear. Allman Sports International has everything you need to play your best and look great doing. For a free catalog, call 1-800-BESTIC.
Power play situation gives the Bandits another opportunity as Derek Keenan scores his third goal of the night.
Well, we watch it again. Keenan, their leading scorer, is not disappointing the Buffalo fans tonight. And again, I wouldn't want to beat Steven Deitrich. They're just letting the Buffalo Bandits inside all night on him. Doesn't have a chance to get his head into the game.
5:18 to go in the quarter. And for the first time in a long time, both teams at full strength. Keenan loses control of the ball. Jackson tried to come away with it. Emick takes the shot. Hall off the rebound. Up top to Emick. His shot bounces wide. 30 seconds. regulation possession goes to the Thunder. Quick restart, Jeff Jackson. Here's Tony Millon. Millon with a move around Emick. Off balance, takes the shot, blocked on the outside. Kerwick comes away with a rebound. Jackson with a shot. It's wide and over the top.
Baltimore's looking like they're in desperation now. Instead of playing and moving the ball and looking for the open man cutting, they're taking shots from the outside. Those aren't their best shots. That's not the way they've won games in the past. They've got to break inside.
4:24 to go. 21-13. And remember, it's only the third quarter. Illegal pick, the call. That will give the ball back to the Thunder. Here's Brian Kronberger on the break. Kronberger with a shot. Save, Gerrie. Bissell on the counterattack to Darris Kilgour. Kilgour's shot pulled in by Steven Deitrich. Pile up in front of the goal. Deitrich goes tumbling. But on the counterattack, here's Jeff Jackson. Jackson fires the shot. It goes wide. There is Kilgour to Bissell. It's a one-on-two situation. Bissell's shot goes high.
It looks like every time the ball bounces, it seems like it's bouncing in Buffalo's favor tonight. It's just happening that way. Rebounds, loose balls, whatever the situation. And Baltimore sometimes taking one shot, and that's all they're getting.
Rick Sowell with a shot. Save Gerrie.
They love Bill Gerrie here.
Going to see another penalty. Cross-check the call. 3:25 to go. Third quarter, 21-13. As Bill Kerr will take a seat in the penalty box.
Well, you know what's interesting is Buffalo doesn't hurt them to be a man down, because even though they're going to play 4-5 here, they scored 4 shorthanded goals in the first half with one fewer man on the floor.
And in some cases, 2. Well, Jeff Jackson makes that a quick power play with a shot in the goal to make it 21-14, pulling the Thunder within 7. That was the number that they came back against the Boston Blazers.
And they've done it before. Can they do it again? The way Bill Gerrie's playing, I'd say no, they can't. But at the same time, they have the tenacity to make this a much closer game. We'll see right now. The leaders are doing it for him. Jeff Jackson, as we talked about at the top of the show, he's going to help them. They got to count on Ricky Sowell. And let's not forget about Pat Welsh.
Faceoff flies into the stands. We'll try it again. It'll be Mark Burnham for the Bandits. Dan Britton for the Thunder. And Vince Angotti picks it up. Vince Angotti going all the way, takes the shot, and Gerrie with a save. Tim Welsh picks it up, looking for the centering pass. Gets it to Rick Sowell. Sowell circles. In front for Britton. His shot won't go.
That's what you call teamwork there. Burnham jumped in the goal with his goaltender to block that open goal. And beautiful teamwork and ball passing. We talk about it over and over again. Ricky Sowell, Jeff Jackson, those are the guys that are doing it for Baltimore.
Rick Sowell with the goal.
We just see excellent teamwork here. The ball being moved side to side. Ricky Sowell gets a nice shot before Gerrie can get back into position. Just take a look at the nice ball movement. Again, that's what you want to do in this game. You want to move the goalie from side to side. We've got a 6-goal differential. Let's not count them out. Goaltenders are getting tired. Gerrie's been in there the whole game. That'll weigh in the fourth quarter.
Here's Tony Millon to Rick Sowell to Fred Haas with a shot and the goal. And the Baltimore Thunder are on the comeback trail.
These fans are up here. The music's blaring. They think they have a comfortable lead, but we know differently.
One more time, Tony Millon started it.
I'll tell you, he's a heads-up rookie. He made this thing happen. Ricky Sowell on the other end, an assist. Feeds it across nicely to Haas. Scores a nice one-on-one goal.
We talked about Rick Sowell having a couple goals, but he has quite a few assists on the night.
And Fred Haas, out of Loyola in Maryland, he was one of the leading scorers at midfield for them. Last year, this is his rookie year in the MILL.
Kevin Alexander against Dan Britton. Very important faceoff. And the faceoff won by the Thunder. Tony Millon comes away with it. The rookie with a shot save. Gerrie. Millon picks up the rebound, tried to flip it over to Rick Sowell. Instead, it might turn into a counterattack. Ball dumped into the corner. Deitrich picks it up. Ball hits the official. Tony Millon comes away with it, holding the call. We're going to take a break. We will be back with more 21-16 on Prime Network.
Traveling, stay with the teams of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. Stay in Baltimore, the Sheraton Inner Harbor. In Boston, the Holiday Inn Boston Brookline. In Buffalo, the Radisson Hotel and Suites. In Detroit, the Radisson Hotel Pontchartrain. In New York, the Long Island Marriott Hotel and Conference Center. In Philadelphia, the Airport Hilton Inn. And in Pittsburgh, the Best Western Parkway Center Inn. All official hotels of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League.
Chocolate.
Dunkin' Donuts introduces new minis. They're smaller than our regular donuts, so now you don't have to choose just one. You can have more of your favorites each time you come in.
No, the frosted, the coffee rolls, the butternut, the glaze.
Buy plenty of new Dunkin' Minis so you won't get caught short.
The NCAA High School and College Cheerleading Championships return to Nesson Friday night starting at 10. Don't miss a jump, vault, or tumble in this always exciting competition. That's Friday night starting at 10 on Nesson, your ticket to the best in sports action.
Lightning fast, Brian Kronberger with a goal.
Well, we see a good ball movement here. John Holhouse over to Kronberger, takes that shot. And again, it might be a tired Bill Gerrie in the Buffalo goal.
Four goals! The deficit for the Baltimore Thunder with 1:37 to go in the third quarter.
Let's go, Buffalo!
Tim Welsh over to the corner. Jackson can't control it. Nine on the shot clock. The ball loose behind the crease. Gerrie reels it in. They'll give it to Darris Kilgour. The Bandits shorthanded for the next 1:24, which will run out the quarter unless the Thunder gets the power play goal. There you take a look at the saves. Bill Gerrie, a dominant factor.
Hey, no question about it, and he's the difference, but at the same time, he's getting tired. Baltimore, on the other hand, is leading in shots. They continue at this pace with a tired goaltender in the Buffalo Bandit net. That could make a difference in the comeback.
Baltimore Thunder calls timeout with less than a minute to go in the third quarter. 21-17 the score here at the Odd in Buffalo.
It's that experience that Baltimore has on the team between Jackson and Sowell and Pat Welsh and Tim Welsh. They've got a lot of experience. Again, they came from the championship game last year, and they've got a quality team out here.
John Stewart's team has been to the championship. That was last year. This year, you could be there, too. The Major Indoor Lacrosse League U.S. Air Flyaway Contest to the World Championship. 9200 Ward Parkway, Suite 500, Kansas City, Missouri. 64114, send your name, address, and phone number. And you could be there, courtesy of U.S. Air. Taking a look at the playoff format. In each division, second place plays the third place team. Winner gets the division champion. And the two games that are confirmed in Philadelphia at the Spectrum on the 29th at Joe Louis Arena, April 4th in Detroit. Tickets available at all the usual outlets in those cities. Less than a minute to go as Jeff Jackson starts it off. Shorthanded situation, or excuse me, power play situation for the Thunder as Jeff Jackson takes the shot. 45 seconds to go in the quarter.
I think that was a key man up for Baltimore. A goal there would have given them that just extra impetus going into the fourth quarter. Not to say they're not on a roll, they are.
10 on the shot clock as Darris Kilgour takes it just inside the restraining line. Kilgour spins, looking for the shot. Behind the back, it won't go. Veltman with a follow-up, that shot won't go. Tie up in the corner with 16 seconds to go, and the Thunder will get possession for the final barrage of the quarter.
Anything can happen in the MILL. We're counting down the 10-second clock.
Here's Kerwin to Curry with six.
I don't know if they know that the shot clock's running down. They did.
Shot taken by Kronberger in the final second. And after three periods of play, it's a four-goal lacrosse game. Buffalo Bandits, 21. Baltimore Thunder, 17 on Prime Network. Buffalo Bandits, 21.
Take their time. They don't have to be rushed with shots because they've got the lead.
Faceoff flies into the Thunder. Thunder bench. And possession will belong to the Bandits. It's very loud in here. It's hard to think. There is Kilgour trying to go across the front of the crease, pushing the call possession to the Bandits. This is John Tavares going up against and got it around the pick from Mahar. Kerr. Tavares!
A great save by Deitrich. Another great save by Deitrich. Baltimore's playing good defense as a team. They're playing better defense now than they played in the first half, but they've got to play and get a good shot on offense.
Two shots taken by Dan Britt. Nothing getting by Bill Gerrie.
A little fancy stuff on his own there behind the back pass, showing that goaltenders have good stick work as well.
And every time a goal is scored by the Bandits, that record will go up. The one that you saw just moments ago. Here's Meridian. Today from outside, Deitrich with a stop. Jim Welsh bringing it up. 7:35 to go from the odd in Buffalo. Very audible fans, if you'll pardon the very bad pun. Jackson with the shot, saved by Gerrie.
These Buffalo fans were given a scare a while ago. They cut it down. Baltimore cut the lead to four. Baltimore looked strong. Gerrie looked tired. They have not been taking a lot of shots on him.
Kerwick on the 3-on-2. Welsh in front of goal, and a penalty will be called. 7:06 to go, 24-18. And there's a man who is head-to-head with Jim Kelly on the most popular list of sports figures these days, at least in the town of Buffalo. Well, he has played the whole game.
He's got 45 saves on the night. The record's 53. I don't think he's the record's in jeopardy of being broken, which is held by Teddy Sawicki and tied with by Glenn Little of the old Washington Wave team.
Both the Thunder and the Bandits set a new good record.
Here is Jackson
for a total goal.
One touch by Kerwick. Jackson on the other side. This is Curry. Ball stolen away. Beautiful play by Jim Veltman.
But they do it time and time again. They're playing with one fewer players on the field, and they steal the ball away. Baltimore is not taking advantage of that extra player.
Veltman trying the shot. Deitrich bounces on top of it.
An acrobatic save and a heck of a save.
63-57, the shots on goal. You think when they made that shot clock back in the old days that they'd ever see a total like that for any sport?
Well, not only the total shots, but the number of saves, the number of goals.
Tavares tries. Keenan.
Luckily, Todd Curry got his stick on that just at the end. Otherwise, that would have been the 25th goal for Buffalo. Buffalo very disciplined.
Here's Keenan. 1 second on the shot clock, and that's a 30-second violation.
30-second clock violation against Buffalo. Thunder takes over.
Thunder.
Who's their leader? Jeff Jackson. They've got their first line out there with Sowell, Jackson, and Curry.
Timeout called by the Baltimore Thunder with 5:34 to go in the game. 24-18, Bandits putting on a show here at the Odd.
Take a ride with Richard Marx down Rush Street.
I don't know why I keep coming back to you, baby. I don't know why I keep coming back.
Rush Street, the new album from Richard Marx.
To you, baby.
I'm Rick Sowell of the Baltimore Thunder, and I'm going to score a bunch of goals tonight.
We'll see about that, and you can see it on the Mill Home video.
This exciting video is full of the greatest action from the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. To order, send a cashier's check or money order for $9.95. That's right, only $9.95 plus $3 postage and handling to Mill Home Video, 9200 Ward Parkway, Suite 500, Kansas City, Missouri, 64114. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery.
If you couldn't get a seat for this one, you could get a ticket. You just have to stand up here at the Odd in Buffalo. Tonight's game brought to you in part by the Radisson Hotel and Suites, the official headquarters of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League in Buffalo. A lot of these players are going to have to rest well after this one. 24-18 the score, 4:24 to go. Some of the fans battling for the ball behind the glass. 4:20, clock rolling. The Bandits on their way to their fourth consecutive win, barring a miracle by the Thunder. Moranian with 15 seconds on the shot clock.
They are using the entire shot clock.
Day takes the shot.
You've got to be impressed with Steven Deitrich at this point in time.
Well, Deitrich just looks down at what is happening in front of him.
I think that's frustration. Tony Millon drops his gloves and takes on a Buffalo Bandit.
Darris Kilgour, who has been kicked out of two games this year.
Well, what's hard to believe is Darris Kilgour is over 6 foot, 215 pounds. Get this, Tony Millon, 5'10", 180. That's 45-pound difference.
I don't know if they could get the tail of the tape up there that quickly.
Well, it didn't look like an even matchup to me, but Tony Millon didn't care at this point in time.
Just under 4 minutes to go. There is Kilgour.
It's been a physical game all night, Greg. I mean, there's no doubt about it. There's been a lot of penalties, and both these teams are scrapping for that playoff spot.
A lot of shots, a total of 126 shots on goal for both teams. One nice thing about the Odd here in Buffalo, you look up at the shot clock and you also get to know what the weather is outside. Temperature, a nice, warm 20 degrees. Playoff games coming up in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. Get your tickets if you are in Philadelphia or Detroit. The Spectrum on the 29th. Joe Louis Arena on April the 4th. Tickets are available now at all the usual ticket outlets in those cities. Of course, stay with us all season long for action on Prime Network. It brings you the U.S. Air Fly Away Contest to the World Championship. 1-900-226-MILL. $2 per minute if you want to enter by phone. The site to be determined.
Well, if Darris Kilgour is heading to the locker room, he's done with just under 4 minutes to go in the game.
He's running to enter the flyaway promotion. You see, it's getting late in the evening and 20 degrees. Ironically enough, this team is so hot that it was 18 degrees when we arrived at the Odd. They've heated up the entire town by 2 degrees.
And you know, it's interesting, a lot of games where it's a 6-goal difference at the end, you see a lot of empty seats, people on their way out. There aren't too many empty seats here. People want to see their Buffalo Bandits, and they have come a long way from the beginning of the season to a contender for the championship.
Tony Millon making his way off the field. Waving to the fans as he goes. Greetings all. As we are in a nice little nest here at the Odd in Buffalo. Say hello to some of our friends. $3.59 to go. 24-18 the score. Time to start thinking about an MVP. Have to go defensively with Gerrie, offensively with Derek Keenan.
Yeah, Gerrie has had a sensational game.
We've kicked him.
I know, and every time I say something, whenever I'm with you, Craig, whenever I'm with you, I can't call the man up plays, I can't call the man down plays, and here we're talking about how good he's playing, and he is playing very well. We watch the replay here, get driving to the goal, comes back left, it's a bounce shot, and those bounce shots are tricky right through the five hole, right between his legs.
Jeff Jackson with goal number 19, his third goal of the night. Kevin Alexander ready for the faceoff. No, Baltimore, Jeff Jackson looking on.
We got Fred Haas facing off for Baltimore. Hey, this game is not over. Five goal difference, it's not over.
You are correct, honest. We've seen some miracle comebacks. Veltman will try to prevent any chance of a miracle. Deitrich with a nice save with the arm pad. Veltman on the rebound.
But if Baltimore's going to have any chance, they've got to pick up every loose ball that's out there. They've got to go for every one of them.
And I'm really surprised that Buffalo trying the quick shots. You'd think they'd want to hold it a little bit. Here's Rick Sowell. Speaking of a team that needs some quick shots, Jeff Jackson with a shot. Save Gerrie.
The other thought you've got to start thinking about is Coach John Stewart for Baltimore, whether or not he wants to pull his goaltender. And again, maybe he's trying to get it down to a two-goal game before he has to do that.
Rick Sowell.
I would take the chance now.
Here's Jeff Jackson with a shot right into the sternum. Shot. Tim Welch is about to bid an early adieu, courtesy of the officials.
I'm not sure I understand that play. Tim Welch was trying, and I don't know who had possession of that ball. If he actually stole it out of Gary's stick, or if it was actually Pat's stick and it was in the air. I don't know that.
Tim Welch taking the long walk back Thunder dressing room.
And there's close to 17,000 people bidding an adieu.
Let's take a look at it again. Right in front of the goal, Tim Welch saying, this is what I meant to do a minute ago, except the whistle had blown.
That's why he got ejected from the game. I missed that. Unsportsmanlike, throwing the ball, he's out of the game.
Is that your MVP, Bill Gerrie? You can really make a good case both ways. Keenan with a four-goal game, and we don't have the assists up here, but I'm sure he's done quite well. And then you've got Gerrie with enough saves to make a lot of people happy.
Well, hold on a second. If Baltimore happens to come back and somebody scores a lot of goals, they might have to consider a Baltimore Thunder player, so don't forget that.
Yeah, Tony Millon with four goals, but he's already said goodnight.
But he had a stellar game for a rookie in this league. He played very well.
Sports Life MVP is Derek.
Tim Welch, he has to leave the arena. Welch says, hey, I paid for my ticket, or I'm getting paid to be here. I want to see the game until it's over.
Well, they just announced in the arena here, the MVP. I'm a little bit surprised because five goals does not a game make.
Well, the five-goal lead. Stick work. Deitrich pinning the ball against the goal. Off the shot by Kevin Alexander.
We'll see what they can do with just under 3 minutes to go. All it takes is five shots, five goals.
But the Thunder have to get those five shots off. There's one. It doesn't do much good. And here comes the Bandits.
And the Bandits are running like it's a first quarter and it's a tie game.
Keenan in front. Alexander with a beautiful shot. Deke, up, down, back of the net it goes.
I'll tell you, Kevin Alexander is in the Canadian Hall of Fame. He's playing like he belongs there tonight.
Now we have a new story. Let's first take a look at this one.
Well, we see Derek Keenan feeds Kevin Alexander. So Kevin not only picks up another goal, Derek Keenan picks up another assist tonight.
And Alexander with the goal. Derek Keenan with his ninth assist. That is a league record. Ties a league record.
Ties a league record for most assists in one game.
Alexander with another goal. And the Bandits one goal away from tying the all-time record for most goals in a game.
That most assist record, excuse me, of eight was from 1987. He broke it with nine. He broke it, and that's been held for since 1987.
Gerrie with another save. He may have a record of his own. I don't know what the most saves is, but he may be getting close to it.
Most saves is 53. Teddy Sawicki and Bob Little, two goalies, share that honor.
Saved by Deitrich.
Buffalo Bandits 25 goals scored by 26.
150 to go.
Let's not forget the record. Most goals in a game is 26. So the next goal by Buffalo will tie that.
And let's see if the Bandits will go for it.
A new Bill record.
Keenan, whose record has just been announced to the crowd. Alexander behind the back. We have a new record.
It's another record broken tonight, tied for the most goals in one game. So the next goal by Buffalo will break the MILL record.
Okay, I got excited.
That's okay.
But it was a great goal.
It was a beautiful goal. The guy's incredible. He's one of the oldest players in the league, and he's still running and playing like he's a youngster.
Now, is he older than you, Tom?
Nobody's older than me.
Well, there you see it in black and white and a little bit of orange. 26 to 19, and we still have a minute 27 to go.
Bandits 26 goals, scored by the 26.
Is this the hottest team in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League, or what?
Well, the announcer here at the odd just announced the 26th goal, and Kevin Alexander, number 26, scored it. He won't forget that.
The fans just found out about the league record. Let's see if they can break it.
And you know what? If they didn't want to break it, they wouldn't put Kevin back out there. Kevin Alexander's back out there. They're serious about breaking his record.
And
it might have been too many players back out on the field. That's the problem. They had five players out there for Buffalo.
Which could be a new league record.
Well, if you look at the penalty box, it looks like a record there. I mean, there's more red and gold, and there's more orange and white and black in the other penalty box.
We'll let you catch some of the sights and sounds of the odd.
You think they'll be that happy when they go outside the 20-degree temperature?
They'll be warm. Last minute of play. And Matt Kerwick hasn't given up. Making it 26-20. Marking the first time that I believe that two teams have gone over 20 goals. At least in 1992.
Now you're right. Detroit 23, Pittsburgh 18. That's for the most goals at 41. And
that was gone long ago.
No, that was broken long time ago. This is great ball movement. And can't blame Gerrie on that one. Baltimore just moved the ball very, very well. Here's this chance with less than a minute to go. Buffalo is on their feet waiting for a record to be broken.
Let's just let you watch it.
25 goals scored by number 4, Pat Curry. Assist number 5.
Veltman trying to get it. Look who's there. Couldn't quite do it. 30 seconds to go. And the Bandits will have one more try. Veltman will start the play. 20 to go.
Kevin Alexander was all alone on the crease. They didn't see him. And that's the guy you want to get the ball to.
Alexander with a shot and a score!
This place is going crazy. They just broke the league record. Most goals in one game.
For that. Four in a row for the Bandits. The hottest team in the league. Picks up another one. We'll wrap it up in a minute.
Around 1900, GMC Truck built America's first gasoline-powered truck and went on to make trucks our only business. A heritage of trucks that, some say, worked a little harder, lasted a little longer. And that's still true today in a truck that gives you the most standard payload and the strongest resale of any full-size pickup. Sierra, from GMC Truck, more proof of the strength of experience.
Hi, I'm Steve Stenerson, Executive Director of the National Lacrosse Foundation, and I'd like you to become involved in America's fastest-growing team sport. For over 30 years, the Foundation has served as the sport's National Development Center and Archives. As a member, you can be kept up to date on dozens of programs and services that include lacrosse magazine, new start programs for first-year teams, equipment safety research, a national network of chapters, and a new museum building that traces the sport's history. For more information, call or write the Lacrosse Foundation in Baltimore, Maryland.
The way to not win in tennis is to think too much about your opponent. Because in tennis, you don't just play the opponent. You've got to play the ball. It's how you play the ball that determines whether your shot is in or out. Whether the point is won or lost. Play the ball better than your opponent, and you'll play winning tennis. Now, you can play the ball and win with this double offer from Tennis Magazine. You'll receive a free half-hour video by Tennis Magazine instruction editor Vic Braden, plus a full year, 12 issues of Tennis Magazine. Call this number now and change the way you play tennis. What a combination. The How to Play Winning Tennis with Vic Braden video, plus the magazine that brings more instruction to more tennis players than any other. Call 800-228-4420 for a full year of Tennis Magazine plus the free video. Just $13.77. Call 800-228-4420 now.
GMC Truck Play of the Game, the strength of experience shown by the Hall of Famer.
Kevin Alexander, a leader on this team, his fifth goal of the evening, and again, sets a record for the MILL with 26 goals in a single game.
Just to show you how pretty this one was.
Well, Kevin had just scored a goal earlier for Buffalo, and the fans were up on their feet cheering for them to score, and they scored this with under 30 seconds to go in the game.
Steven Deitrich couldn't do anything about that one, and the crowd at the Aud absolutely went nuts. 27 goals. Coors Light player of the game. Look at that. 14 points. New MILL record. 10 assists. Another record for the player of the game, Derek Keenan.
He broke two records tonight, and he had a sensational game. And I tell you, he's a rookie, first year in the league, and we're looking for big things from him in the future.
Let's take a look at one of his goals, one of four on the night. This is his final one on a fast break, something Buffalo did all night.
He's a strong player. He comes down, and he takes it to the goal by himself. Goes by the Buffalo defender, and again, a Baltimore defender. Another Baltimore player comes in. He still has the goal in mind and puts it past Deitrich.
Take a look at the scoring leaders for tonight's game. First for the Baltimore Thunder, the rookie Tony Millon leading the way.
Sensational game. And by the way, Brian Kronberger said he'd have a hat trick. He did. And Jeff Jackson, always steady, had a hat trick also.
Kevin Alexander leading the way with 5 goals. Tavares and Keenan with 4 each. The scoring leaders for the Bandits. 140 shots, 47 goals in this one. A lot of excitement. A lot of excitement coming up for the playoffs, too.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what's going to take Buffalo into the playoffs is a hot goaltender. Bill Gerrie had a great game tonight.
Let's take a look at the playoff format, bring you up to date once again. Second place takes on third place. The winner of that takes on the division winner. Which games do we know definitely about? The two you're about to see here. At the Spectrum on a Sunday night, March the 29th. Saturday night, April 4th, at the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Tickets available now. We'll tell you about our game next week. Coming up, we'll see the Bandits, the hottest team in lacrosse next week. We'll tell you more about it when we return on Prime Network. Tonight's Major Indoor Lacrosse League Game of the Week has been brought to you by Coors Light. It's the right beer now. By U.S. Air. U.S. Air begins with you. By Reebok. Life is short. Play hard. By Brian Lacrosse. The power behind the game. And by GMC Truck. The strength of experience. Next week, we will be at what they affectionately known as the Garden to see the hottest team in lacrosse, the Buffalo Bandits, go up against the Boston Blazers. If the Bandits can keep it going, they could be seeing a National Division title in their future. There you take a look at some happy people here in Buffalo. Some quick comments, Bill?
Well, Buffalo did not disappoint their hometown crowd. Lots of records, and we look forward to them in the playoffs.
Lots of records. We will see them next week. For Bill Barroza, this is Craig Johnson. So long, everybody, from a jam-packed audience.